is in town to play the Canberra Colts. Game two of the Eddie Mountain Subway Series Finals. And the Canberra Colts from the first game, 5-2. No shots on goal were close. Both teams are pretty evenly matched. Should be a good draw tonight, and we'll have some excitement.
The Subway Series, the Mets and the Yankees.
Yep.
And the Dodgers and Giants.
Dodgers and Giants.
Dodgers and Giants.
That was a start. Now we're already going at it here. Trey Minnick and Rick Allen. And these are the two teams very similar in size, very similar in talent and the forward line. The defense is very similar. Goaltending is pretty close.
A little bit of a no-lose situation for Bobby Murdoch because one team he coached last year, and he left him with a nucleus of players, and Kevin McKay and Mike Vandekamp have picked up on that, obviously, in my affairs. But in all the years we've known Bobby, there's not many arguments he's ever lost, and I don't know that he'll lose this one. Maybe a little added incentive for the Fleming team to beat the man that left them, I guess, on the doorstep last year, after leading them to the Southern Division title. And into the finals against Prince George, who went on to BCJ. We'll talk more about that later.
Yes, we will.
I guess in talking with the people that were in Fernie and anybody that saw the game, it was fairly lackluster affair in terms of intensity. Everybody seemed to feel that nerves was had a little bit to play with it. Both teams were a little nervous, kind of nervous going into Fernie. But sometimes that's an advantage, and you'd like to have that. If you go into a barn and you lose, you're forced to lose first game of the series. And if you can go in and win that first game like the Colts did, then you're taking away home ice advantage. And the pressure now, Fernie's getting pressure in Fernie, he's going to feel more pressure to play well here, making sure they don't go back home down 2-0.
Okay, and how did they get here? Fernie beat Kimberley after beating Castlegar in 6 games. They beat Kimberley in 4. And the Colts beat Nelson in 4 after losing to Kimberley in 7. So we'll talk a little bit about that later too. But I get the feeling from some of the fans that this system of the playoffs they're having this year is a little bit weird in that there was a wild card. But there has been a precedent set in Major Junior that has happened before. It has happened in other places. And if you go to any rep team provincial playoffs, you can get beat in the round robin 2 or 3 times and still win the convention. So really no big deal. Everybody is just more games to watch. You get to get out Saturday night,
yep.
And you got a haircut.
Well,
I know you got a haircut. You went and won $607 in the playoff, 50-50. You didn't give any to your buddy, Calvin McCabe, for the ticket, and you certainly didn't give any to me, so I could go and eat tonight.
Well, you certainly had the opportunity to come with me, but I did leave after the 50-50 there. There were 2,041 fans in the building. 50-50 was $1,312 bucks, but they managed somehow to take 2 winning tickets. So it was a bit of a dogfight.
Well, you tested yours at 8:30. You got yours in there.
So I did lose $56 for the Trail Smoke Eaters. Now it's probably the total beat of the one of the crowds they had last year.
Yes,
no, certainly not this year.
And you will talk to Calvin in the first intermission. And while we wait for that, Tom Danicus got a few announcements to make, and let's go and listen to him as we see him in the middle of the ring.
Thank you.
For tonight, for Ferdy, the head coach is Mike Vandekamp, the assistant coach is Larry Smith, the GM is Kevin McKay, the trainer is George Robot and Daryl Leslie. Head coach for the Colts is Bob Murdoch, assistant coach is Mel Veclin, Jay Nelson is the GM president, the trainers are Gary Hansen and Brian Newman.
Thank you.
have it all the first team All-Stars. Three from the Cranbrook Colts. They have a second team All-Star. The Ghost Riders have the All-Star goaltender, first team All-Star goaltender, and the second team All-Star center. The Colts have the Coach of the Year and the second team All-Star GM. That's a new one.
I guess
so off of that, they should win.
I'd like to probably put a note in here as being a little upset that either my own roommate from last year, Big Gary Hansen, or Brian Newman didn't make the first or second team as All-Star trainer.
Right.
What happened then?
Well, Brian has to go to the AFL
for all, so maybe it's part of that. I'm a little upset about that. I guess if you can have All-Star GMs, you should have All-Star trainers. What about Sick Boy?
Goals against average and a phenomenal 9.28 save percentage, and that's about what it was in the regular season as well. Yes, he hasn't fallen at all.
Well, he's done a good job, I think. And I can remember talking. It was earlier in the season, but late in the season in general with Kevin McKay when Wade was out hurt. He said their team was just not was the same. It didn't have to do anything to do with the talent of the goalies they had in there, but with the confidence that the rest of the Ghost Riders had with Wade. Oh.
Subway people. We got to drop the seafood Subway.
You probably hurt yourself diving for it from here. But Wade on his return picked up right where he left off, and I think he's still a left player with Seattle.
Yep.
And obviously they still have some confidence in him. I'm involved a little bit in that game, and you can't miss too many games or get hurt, you know, with some kind of injury like that the GMs up in Seattle or Tri-City or Spokane don't start looking elsewhere and in a hurry. So. No, and Wade was a goaltender that Bobby didn't have any second thoughts about heading to last year. You had Cam Morris, who was an All-Star goaltender, but a couple games we played him last year, Cam let in two bad goals, that was it. He was done for the night. So, and Wade played with a lot of the ex-Colts, but a lot of the Colts from last year. He was an ex-Intermere Columbia Valley Rocky, and he seemed to have something over those guys. They just couldn't beat him. So, although there isn't as many members from the Rockies and the Colts this year as there was last year, he still has a little bit of magic.
While we get ready to drop the puck, Glenn Brown is the referee, Brian Lazon and Greg Lavallee are the linesmen, and we've certainly got a veteran official staff here. Lega Scott, his brother Kent, is not playing for the Ghost Riders. Some funny maneuvering there, but here's Scott Lega with the puck, and he'll just shoot it down the ice, and now go figures. Right on Dubowitz, there's the first save of the night. Ghost Riders in some difficulty in their own zone as Scott Ford coughs the puck up. Dennis Moon, Slodovnik, and Mike Fischel. That's the Black Aces line. And they get an offside, and Chris Ford and Jeremy Slodovnik didn't hear the whistle.
Scott Ford?
Scott Ford.
Ford had a little bit of problem when the puck gets it out, and this is where Kramer's probably been better than any team that I've seen this year in this late carry. That if you make a mistake in your zone, they forecheck so well that they can generate a lot of scoring opportunities off that. Bernie Ford's strength over anybody else is the ability of their defensemen to carry the puck out of danger. We'll see if that occurs for us again.
Here's Stefan Stromquist, and they have a big defense through the Ghost Riders. This center is Ben Thornberry. He's over the line and falls down and is pushed down by Jeff Oldenberger, and Sean Herdman gets an easy first save. This is already, we have seen more intensity in the first 55 seconds of this game than we did as the first two periods of the whole Nelson Leeds Cranbrook Colts fourth game.
Maybe six periods that I saw.
Kennedy and Spencer, the first and second All-Star center, and Spencer beats Kennedy on the draw. Mike Fordham, a first All-Star winger, bats the puck to center, and Joel Domofsov dumps it right back in. Jeff Oldenburger. As the Ghostwriters go after the Colts defense to turn the puck over, but Dave Oleta was there. A backhand pass off the skates to Spencer, and here's Steckman. He can't get by Domofsov, and the shot is deflected into the sand.
Well, there's, in one little shift, Dave Oleta showed you his work. He had the puck in the corner, threw the puck around, now that puck's going to come out. Spencer couldn't get the puck out, and come back around. And Jeff Oldenburger picked the puck up, popped it up in front of his net, and then Dave Oleta just stepped in there and took that puck outside the blue line, and a nice race out left half off the set of skate goes. Beckman got a net.
Brooke rips it, and Dubowitz is forced to make the save. Kevin Martin, a late season acquisition for the Ghost Riders, and a good one, dumps the puck in deep. Herdman is forced to play it. Ghost Riders on the puck pass. Jeff Scott gets the puck away from Hofstra, and Malvin is forced to come into the corner. On the side is McLeod, off the boards and out. Brooke will go after Brandvold, and Brooke had four goals and one assist in a 5-2 Colts win the other night. Martin won't get out. McGowan coughs the puck up, Brooke in the corner, back, intended for McLeod, he can't get it, the puck is at center. In his own zone is Scott Legg, some difficulty, they get away from the check, Matt Maltman, off of Brooke's back, and he'll flip it to the corner, the Colts on a change. Here's McGowan, he didn't see Hofstad, it was wide open at the Colts line. Brad Patterson is dealt it as we start to get physical. Patterson's pass to Jacob Beck. Here's Bailey. In. Right in. Dubowitz stones it. It's ours. Second effort. Morgan Bailey. 1-0. And we'll see this again. And here's Bailey. Dubowitz stops the first, and Bailey whaps it. And in it goes. So the Colts score first in their own rink with 2 minutes and 28 seconds gone. Bailey flips the puck to center. And right back to the Colts line. Bailey away. Jacobek was loose. And the play is offside as Patterson picks the puck up.
A few horrible plays. And when you make bad plays like that, Jerry, the puck should end up in the goal. And you really got to think, when you get to this level, if you're going to play like that, these are pretty going to be gone in fourth straight, there's no doubt. You know, they got to come out and be prepared to play. McGowan had the puck. All he had to do is throw the puck up, clear the zone. Instead, he's got his head tied to the top of the skates and tried to lug it to the blue line, lost it. And the puck gets turned over, and he goes off the ice.
Colts right back at it. It's Ford now for the Ghost Riders. Won't get away from Kodovnik. The puck goes by Walido as he belts Kennedy. Becker right in the spot. Loose to Thornburg. And Herman, a great save. Good escape. And Thornburg, dangerous, the leading point getter for the Ghost Riders. And boy, the puck is a hot potato here. Anthony Baldwin rings the board. Jeff Scott fans. Brad Kennedy can't get away from Scott. A good defensive play after a poor one. On the side, Ghost Riders to center. Here's Thornburg with Redmond. Thornburg's over the line. Kodovnik gets a piece of him. Kennedy in deep. Redmond, backhander into the slot. Kodovnik comes away. 2-on-2 to center. He'll take a long shot. Dubowitz has it. And Kodovnik in after the whistle. Good start, Ruck.
Well, good start for Kodovnik. The big guy sees Ferdy playing with no confidence at all. They got a great turnover. Ben Thornberry, you know, a horrible pass by Corey Becker right on Thornberry's stick. He gets the shot. The puck comes to Travis Redman. Instead of setting up the puck up, turning around to face the plate, he throws the puck backwards and grabs the three guys in the zone. They get no chance. Now that's a little bit of catch with the Travis coming back. I think that they're nervous, and now they're down one, and they're going to start pressing. That's what Bobby wanted.
Here's Stromquist on this side, the center. From the Ghost Riders, Corkle passes behind Babcock. Center. His pass doesn't get to Sekman. Here's Scott Vega. The puck is knocked down at the line, and Sekman gets it in deeper where Spencer will pick it up. Onto the side is Corkle. Won't get out. The puck does come out to Moskov. Behind Babcock, he's belted by Lega, and that'll be icing.
Spencer stepped up to take that pass away and didn't play the puck. There was no ice. And Scott Rager got away with one. He stepped in the bad puck and gave him the knee first. And I think in this already carried it. And we saw this against Nelson. If Spencer's going to come in and beat these guys, they've got to get the puck deep in the corner of the zone, make those big guys turn, keep the puck, and put pressure on them. And that's what cost Nelson is that they could play with Sandbrook in the neutral zone, and they couldn't handle the big guys down low or in Sandbrook's zone.
Well, or didn't want to go there. Here come the Ghost Riders. Kevin Martin tries to beat Flea, Colt, and doesn't, and back is Branvold, and he'll try it. Branvold on this side, a long pass by Zimmerman over Wolito's stick, and Oldenburger will go back. Looking for somebody to pass to, finds McLeod. Brook is wide open. He'll shoot it high over top of the net. McLeod on the puck has to go over stick, and Kevin Martin gets away from Maltman. Martin to center. Got a bit of room against Oldenburger. Right in is Martin. Herdman's out. A centering pass. Hofstra couldn't find the handle. And Oldenburger gets undressed. And Herdman saves him. Here they come again, Ghost Riders. Zimmerman pass, and Wolito chops it. Awful.
Now Brian returns the ref.
5 minutes and 20 seconds gone in the first period. Morgan Beatty's first goal of the year, or the playoffs, and the Colts lead the Ghost Riders 1-0.
A good move by Kevin Martin, but another saving play by Dave Wolito standing in front of the net. Make sure that Hofstrand couldn't get his stick in the puck and then got the puck out.
Jankovic is nailed by Baldwin. Dublowicz, one of the better goaltenders at playing the puck, gives it to Porter, who just scoops it to the line, and back they'll start again as Baldwin is there. Baldwin with some room on his backhand. It's two whaps from Jankovic, but the puck comes to center. Boom dumps it in. Here's Porter on a loose puck. Boom in. Right in. His backhander was wide. He had nothing to shoot at. Jankovic gives it away. Boom. Tries to get it to the corner. It's deflected. There's a break. Here's Bailey again. Right in. Over top of the net. Wow. Fedotnik hammers the puck in and he'll chase it. Dublowicz is out. Boom. Off the boards to center. Becker. To Fischel. Here's Fedotnik. He drills one. McGowan stands there and makes a save. Dennis Moon gets three or four chops at Demoskov, who's now away to center. And Moon gets a stick in Demoskov in his leg. Fischel is wrapped by Stefan Stromquist. Kennedy won't get past Wolito as we get some physical play. Here's Wolito with Fischel. Over the line. Here's Fischel. Right in. Scores! 2-0.
Well, that goal right there, Terry, is the fault of, you can see Ben Thornburg coming in and Brad Kennedy.
Horrible change.
Horrible, horrible. I'll tell you what, Dave Wolito scares people standing still, and he scared them so badly, they decided to stand still and skate away. If we could back that up, it was right in front of the Fernie bench.
There it is, there.
Thornburg just let him go, and he was still standing there waiting for somebody else to do his job. Now, the Moskov got caught out of possession, but right there, the Ghost Riders had a chance. They're calling the timeout now. Now, and I don't know what Mike Vanacap's going to do. If guys that are two-year guys and leaders like Brad Kennedy and then Thornburg are supposed to be his leaders, and neither of them, you know, it was like Dave Valino said boo, and that's, you know, that's great for Cranbrook, but it's got to scare the hell out of Mike.
Well, the Ghost Riders have had three or four chances of their own. The Colts have just given them the puck, and they have their penalty. Morgan Bailey gets one chance and scores a goal. He gets another breakaway and shoots over top of the net. And then we get a 2-on-1, and Fischel and Wolito, two good passes, and Wolito an easy tap.
Well, Dave Wolito, so far, and I don't want to dwell too much because this is a team game, but he's been a difference in every game I've seen.
He's the glue.
Here, he just, along the boards there, he stood still. Brad Kennedy skated 35 feet by him and made a big circle all the way over to the far side. Then Thornburg, as soon as Dave Valino started moving ahead, Thornburg turned his back on him, skated to center ice. Now, you're not going to win any games like that. And, you know, if you let one guy beat you in a team game, then you're in a lot of trouble. Because the Colts have so many other weapons that they're going to bury it.
Well, Mike Vanacap was forced to use his timeout early in the game, something he pretty well had to do, but didn't want to. Puck is at the line, Fordham. Good effort to keep it in. McGowan on the side is Bohm. Here come two Ghost Riders to center. Thornburg around Scott Lega. Beats him again. Thornburg in the slot. On the side is McGowan. A shot and Herdman. 15 feet out. Makes a good save with the toe pad. The cross ice pass off the skate of Ryan Lauzon. Prevents an icing for them. Here's Stekman and Spencer. 2-on-1. Spencer! Denver, it's a great save. There is no Ghost Rider defense to be seen. They are ghosts.
Here's the thing, too, Terry, is that you're not going to beat Cranbrook sending three guys so deep that they get caught in. They just turn the puck over. You know what? They might not be the best team in their own zone, but I'll tell you what, in the neutral zone on in, they're the best in the league, and that turnover there was caused. McGowan shot the puck, nobody in front, three pretty guys didn't want anything to do with Cranbrook's big D-men. They're standing behind the goal line, and they got trapped.
Ghost Riders Baldwin. On the other side is Bolger. He can't get out. McLeod is bodied. Ford against Maltman. Behind the net is McLeod. Maltman on the side now. The Colts. 10 of Ghost Riders in. Brooke will go after the puck. He's bodied off the puck. Brandon Babcock will be chased and bodied by McLeod. Here's Wolito. And Brooke couldn't get a stick on it. Dublowitz stops it. Wolito again, a one-timer. That doesn't get through. A crowd. Oldenburger's body. Ghost Riders a long pass, and that'll be icing.
Well, everybody has said, you know, we can't wait till this series starts. You know, we want to see some good hockey. And we did see a little bit of intensity from Purdy in the first 55 seconds. The game, and that was the only intensity they showed. So maybe, you know, I made a snap judgment. I thought they were coming here ready to play. They're back on their heels, and they get so afraid of Cranbrook man on man, they can't beat anybody to the puck because they wait and react to where that player goes to the puck. You know, they don't have any confidence in themselves that they can play off the puck.
Derek J. Quebec, who has missed a lot of the playoffs, he's only played in 7 games and has not been his usual pep because of an injury, is now tossed into the faceoff circle. Stormquist on the other side. Here come the Ghost Riders. Zimmerman, the captain. He'll go against Jeff Scott, flips the puck to the corner. Scott Lego will ring the board. Bailey lets it go by to Moskov. A floater at the net. And we get a faceoff in the cold zone, a rarity so far.
But just little things like that. You got your captain, Chad Zimmerman. He doesn't want to take the shot on that, which is fine. But he throws it right at Herdman, and all he does is set it up so that the Cranbrook defense can walk right onto it. You know, he's got to throw that into one corner or the other, Terry, and make that defenseman turn and go get the puck under some pressure.
Zimmerman against Jacob Beck. Last year, Zimmerman was a thorn on the faceoff circle, as you well remember, for the Cranbrook Colts. He wins another one. A wrister by Martin, but it's deflected. Back to the point. Strongquist gets by Brad Patterson. Pass in the slot. And back to Strongquist. As the Ghost Riders get a little pressure here. But Jeff Scott rings the board. Bailey's there. Off the boards. Demoskov keeps it in. His shot is Jeff Scott, who's up by the blue line. Brad Patterson. Away for the Colts. He'll go against Strongquist, who falls, and Patterson shoots it to the corners. The Colts are out of chains. Jacobek tags him up with a puck. It's down the ice, and no icing as the Ghost Riders are out of chains now. Zimmerman will body Wolito, sort of. The puck comes to center and back the other way. Here's Nick McGowan. As Fisher will chase him. On the side is Ryan Porter. Look how he gets crunched. Dennis Moon. His shot is just high. Slavik is bodied by Corkle, and he ends up on the board. Ryan Porter won't get out against Wolito. And doesn't want any part of Wolito. Here's Slavik on the other side. Fans on the puck. Zimmerman comes up with it and flips it to Wolito at center. Wolito right back in. It's a Colts change. A long pass to center all by himself. Was boom, and he didn't go anywhere. Jeff Scott misses it, and Scott Lega back. As the Colts have both teams physical, but the Colts kind of getting the better of this. Here's McGowan, a long pass right in second skate. It goes through, and Scott Lega will be chased by Corkle. Lega, a long pass, ends up in the Ghost Rider stick. Neither team passing the puck that well, Rocky. And no icing as Bohm will chase Scott Lega. Off the glass to Spencer. Porter doesn't tie him up. And Steckman off the board. Fordham's away. And Baldwin's there. Fordham gets a stick on him. Loose to Steckman. And Dublowitz, an easy save with a stick. Ford on the side is Porter. And he's had a lot of trouble there. And mercifully goes off the ice. Here's Baldwin. On the other side is Ford. Wolito. And Bohm bump at center, and that's the first time we've seen Wolito move when somebody else hits him. Ford is back. Brooke gets a stick on him. Ford still on the puck. McLeod takes him out of the corner. Corkle. Here comes Thornburg to center. A long shot. High and wide. Kennedy is in. Hack. And taken out of the play by McLeod. Maltman and McLeod win the battle. And out they come. Maltman to center, 2-on-3 with Brooke. Maltman dumps it in and will chase it. A good job against Ford, who grabs him. Ghost Riders, Ford. Hacked by Maltman the other way. Here's a 3-on-2 now. Over the line with Kennedy. A centering pass. And the Colts up with the puck. As that was Redmond on the side. On the side now is Maltman. He'll get a long shot as the Colts on another change. The Colts changing a lot quicker and a lot smoother than the Ghost Riders. Strongquist to Demoskov. And the Ghost Riders, Rocky can see, shifts way too long. Here's Thornburg with Kennedy. And Thornburg gives the puck to Scott. Patterson away. Bailey, another shot. He's died and gone to heaven. But Dublowitz is out and makes an easy save. 7:54 left in the first, 2-0 Colts.
So maybe that timeout helped, you know, Mike called it in the right place, because they've come back with a little bit more intensity, you know, and I think, you know, one thing, and it's one thing to turn the game around, Bohm was headed to the bench, and Wolito ran him, and you'd have to say it did come off the worst of it, because it was even up. They both bounced off each other,
Becker, the puck is loose, and boy, did he have a lot of time. Let's have a look at that one.
And I watched the whole Bernie bench, and it was like they just scored a goal. They're all up cheering and yelling at Wolito. We'll see the shot here. Walk right in the slot. I don't know if that didn't, I don't know if it hit Dublowitz or hit Jacobek in front.
Oh, it hit Dublowitz.
It's like it got him in the top, in the right
hand
shoulder.
Come second on that draw. Somebody has lost a glove to Moskov. Becker at center. His pass is knocked down. Babcock back on the other side. A hard shot. DeVolito's there to Bailey. As Herdman's made four saves with his left skate or left toe. Becker can't come up with the puck, loses Babcock. He goes right by the front of the net. Patterson backhands at the center. And Trent Branville, he'll take a long shot. Herdman, an easy save there. Becker's back. Becker, in his own zone, gives it away. And Herdman, an easy save. Wolito off the board. Branville in some difficulty. And shakes loose. The puck comes to Bolter. He's bodied by Becker. Wolito's back. Off the board. And into the crowd. Well, the Ghost Riders have come back a little bit.
Oh, good play by Bolger. Is it Bolger? Or Kowalski that took the puck in deep. It's been a horrible play by Brandon Babcock. He skated right into him, you know, in behind the net. All he had to do was go to the net, and Kowalski was getting back to his feet. Took himself out of scoring position, took away a scoring opportunity for the Ghost Riders.
Zimmerman and Dennis Moon in the face-off circle. And Jeremy Skłodowski is going to give him instructions. Gone finally drops it. Martin, quick shot, just misses. Lega on the board to Slodovnik, and he is nailed by McGowan, and that's close to interference. Backhander, Slodovnik never did touch the puck, and now what have we got here?
Well, in behind the play, nobody was watching. Mike Fischel ran one of the Ghost Riders. I didn't see who it was. I think it was McGowan after he ran.
Let's see if we can have a look at that, if we can.
He ended up in the bench, and the Fernie team grabbed his stick. And he was trying to pull his stick away, and they were hanging on to it. And when they finally let go, he turned around and jumped and took a punch at him. We'll see it right here. See McGowan coming back. The puck will get turned over here to this far side. Well, it already happened by then. So it wasn't McGowan. It might have been Zimmerman who was on the ice.
Well, Ghost Riders doing all the talking.
I think that Brian Lazon had called it from his spot back on the blue line.
And it looks like Fischel's in the penalty box, but the Ghost Riders...
I think the Ghost Riders are going to get somebody off there, too.
Well, these two teams led the league in penalty minutes, 1-2 during the regular season. And to put it in perspective, they had over 1,000 minutes more than Nelson, who finished sixth in 56 games. But the Colts have played a lot better, or kept themselves out of the box a lot better in the playoffs, and that's to be expected.
I think the referees don't call near as much either.
Well, the players are a little more cooperative. Jeff Scott breaks up a Ghost Rider pass. Podobnik can't get loose. Back is Jeff Scott in his own zone. To Dennis Moon, to Podobnik against McGowan. And another whistle. And McGowan does not like Jeremy Podobnik. So we get a face-off outside the Ghost Rider line. Rocky, the Colts are changing much faster than the Ghost Riders.
I think I think you have to, Terry. There is something to be said for taking a day off in between games, but I think at this time of the season, it just hurts you. You know, I think your legs get heavy and your lungs get heavy. You don't get enough air in them. You certainly know what that's like out there Thursday night.
Ford backhands the puck in deep. On the side, right in front. And Babcock and scores! Brad Bolter, 2-1. And Babcock had the puck go right by him. The Ghost Riders stacked up in an I formation in the slot. And Brad Bolter just ripped it.
Well, here
Babcock misses. And there's Bolter.
No chance, and Sean Herdman made a great play. Kramer's defense there, Dave Valido, and that's what you have to do to beat them. They threw it in deep, and Jeff Oldenburger didn't get to it near in time. Then he positioned himself behind the net for some unknown reason, and puck ended up in behind Sean Herdman, but Herdy made a great play.
Well, not only one Ghostwriter, but two were loose. Babcock against Steckman, who's back. Oldenburger, there's a hot potato. Steckman to the corner to Fordham on the side. The Colts get it out. Ford, a backhander right in the stick of Fordham. He'll flip it to center, not by Kowalski, who hacks Oldenburger. A long shot over the net. Ends up in the Ghost Rider zone. Spencer and Fordham are in. Steckman in the slot, and he's hit from behind us. We'll get a look at that, but I think Bolger's going for cross-checking. If we can have another look at that.
Now there's a call. You know, we talked about it all year. I think it's a great call by Glenn Brown.
Yep.
You know, this is an open ice check. Bolger did hit him from behind, but
he held up.
We've talked about this all year. You know, in between the face-off dots in the middle of the ice, if you get hit from behind, you know, that's sometimes, and it used to be part of the game. Then they started calling it checking from behind, kicking you out of the game. You know, anything along the boards, definitely check it from behind and get him out of the game. But this one, I think Brownie's made a great call here. He keeps Bolger in the game, but he gets a penalty. You know, and it was a penalty.
Well, it was a penalty, but he didn't. It looked like he held up right at the end, and he didn't really try to hurt him. He just tried to knock him down. So, 5:37 left in the first period. Ghost Riders get back on the board, and back in the game. The Colts lead them 2-1. Kelly McLeod. The face-off circle against Michael Hofstrand. Colt on a power play. They win the draw, but the puck goes to the corner. Hofstrand watches McLeod. Maltman slides it wide. Zimmerman on the side. Shoots the puck down the ice. Wolito chased by Hofstrand. Jeff Scott ahead to McLeod at center with Maltman behind him. Here's Maltman. McLeod in the pass is just tipped by Branwold. Behind the net stands Brooks. He can't come out with the puck. Zimmerman won't get it out over the line. Maltman to Scott. He can't get it past Branwold, and Branwold gives it right back to Scott. Brooks bodies Branwold, and there's Strongquist. Off Maltman and out. Hofstrand can't come up with it. Wolito ahead to Jeff Scott. Brook is behind him. Scott going to the net. Is centering pass, and Maltman couldn't get good wood. Here's Wolito. Scott on the side. Fakes a shot to Brook behind the net. Brook can't come out. Back to the point is McLeod. As the Colts defense go in deep, McLeod at the line. Here's Wolito now back in the line. Deep. Brook just tipped. And Dublowitz is there. Heads up play by Wolito, and Brook kept it. Dublowitz makes a great save.
Well, a good play all around, and good heads up puck control by the Colts carry. You know, it did come out one time, but here's the way that you break down that box is you throw a guy around to the outside and then let him slide through the middle. You know, by that time, when you stretch that box out, and what happened there was the box had come out high, and Robbie Brook slipped in behind, and a great, you know, that's like the alley-oop play in basketball.
Off the glass and a crazy bounce. The Ghost Riders, with 37 seconds left, get a reprieve. Wolito was back. And you know he is going to play 40 minutes. On the side, Scott Lega lumbers to center. With Fordham close, going to the net is Spencer. Here's Steckman at the point. His wrist shot won't get through. Ghost Riders. Thornburg couldn't catch up with a bouncing puck. And Herdman shoots it to the corner. And Thornburg goes the other way. Ford, he'll shoot the puck right back in. 7 seconds left in the power play, and Scott Lega away from one check. The Ghost Riders are getting the Colts defensive boxed in and not taking advantage. Ford over Jeff Scott's glove. No icing. Icing.
It's got to be icing.
Not his fault.
With Jeff Scott, not Jeff Oldenburger.
3:28 left in the first. 2-1 Colts.
I think Ben Thornburg is trying to go this series without hitting anybody. He had a chance. I just thought you draw it up when you talk about it in the dressing room. You know, I know Terry is when you have one guy going behind the net, you know, and all Brad Kennedy did was get his stick on Lega, and the next guy's got to come right between the C and the O.
Corey Becker gets another shot, but it's not hard enough, and it's right at Dubowitz. Behind the net, Jacobek centers it. It's knocked down by Stromquist. Off the board, Jeff Scott, the bouncer. Here's Bailey, another shot. Deflected, Dubowitz is down. Bailey's on the loose puck. Jacobek tips it to the corner where Patterson is bodied. And again, in front of the net, Ghost Riders get it to center. Here comes Brandon Babcock. And he went a long ways to stay out of trouble. Jeff Scott brings the boards. Morgan Bailey can't get the puck out. Demoskov is there. Babcock's pass right on Patterson's stick. Brandon Babcock had a good start to the year, Rocky, point-wise. He has tailed off point-wise and play-wise a lot since then. Bolger to center. Here's Babcock against Oldenburger. Around Oldenburger gets a stick on him. Babcock spins and is hauled down by Oldenburger. Mike Fischel flips the puck to center, and the Ghost Riders really backing up. And you know that Jeremy Slodovnik is going to shoot it. A bouncing puck, Dubowitz leaves it. We got some action in the corner. Zimmerman away from the check. Hofstrand loose on the side. Oldenburger chases, but Hofstrand stops. The puck goes to the corner where Wolito is. Wolito on the side, Slodovnik can't get it out. McGowan's shot is knocked down by Oldenburger. And both teams afraid of mishandling the puck, although they've done it many times tonight. Fischel, a hard check there against McGowan. Granvold, as the play slows down, Zimmerman to center. On the side is Hofstrand, his shot is Zimmerman stopped going to the net, and Corey Becker to center. 2-on-2, McLeod and Brooke. Brooke over the line, Maltman trying to go to the net, a bad pass. Ghost Riders away, if they can get away. Hofstrand, 2-on-2 with Martin, now 3-on-2, here's Martin. A pass to Baldwin, and that was behind him. Strange pass.
Ooh, a little kick got hit right in the head over.
Well, we saw nobody there. Bill DeLuca get hit exactly the same way, standing down as the puck goes shooting down that slot there. You have to count.
I noticed on two plays there, Mike Hofstrand made two awful plays at the blue line. He drops the puck behind him. Nobody's calling for the puck. On that time, if he had given it straight to Anthony Baldwin, they had a chance on net.
Ford with 51 seconds left in the period. Brad Kennedy's been invisible in the first period. Just gives the puck to Jeff Scott, and his shot is low and wide, and the Ghost Riders give it away again. Fordham, a backhand pass. Wolito to center. Fordham will try again. Stops and flips it to the corner. Seckman can't forecheck. Here's Kennedy loose. Scott catches him in the soft side. Well, Brad Kennedy complaining about the offside, he should complain about his own play. Second All-Star just nosed out for the scoring leadership, and he has been invisible in a key game in the key period.
Well, Brad Kennedy's turned into a one-way player, Terry. You know, and against this defense, it makes him just about a no-way player. If he's not fast enough to get by the quick guys, and he's not big enough to get by the big guys, you know, and if he doesn't come out and work hard, which so far he hasn't, you know, he's a liability out there instead of an asset. He would have hoped that the second highest point getter in the league would be an asset during the playoffs, not a liability.
Well, then he wants to be a linesman, too. Stromquist flips the puck down the ice. Here's Wolito, a long pass to center. That will end up on Dubowitz's stick. 15 seconds left. Ghost Rider, Thornburg with some speed to center. He'll go against Scott, a drop pass right in the stick of Seckman. 3 seconds, Fordham rolls the puck in. Look get a strange ending. Strange last 3 or 4 minutes of this period. Looks like neither team wanted the puck.
Well, there, Terry, once again, I think this is a case of Cranbrook keeping Fernie in this game. 2-1 deficit, but it was the one bad turnover Fernie capitalized on. But, you know, Morgan Bailey had 4 chances himself. Corey Becker had a great chance. Mike Fordham had a great chance.
Well, the Colts have had lots of chances. Bibbo made 15 saves. A lot of them were easy, but he had some real tough ones as well. Bailey missed on 2 breakaways, basically. 1 clean-cut breakaway and another eyeball-to-eyeball from the slot. The Colts get 2 goals. The Ghost Riders get 1. The Colts lead 2-1. They lead the series 1-0. And in the first intermission, you're going to talk to the only guy that talks more than you.
You?
Kelvin McKay. Kelvin McKay. And while we get a word from our sponsors and wait for Mike Makowski to take the Zamboni around the ice a few times while Kelvin gets in. And we all know that Kelvin did a great job in trail this year. His team ended up losing to Vernon 4-1 in the semifinals, but they lost a couple of key players, especially in the playoffs. Still, the test there was the fans. And the fans, as you already mentioned, one game they had more fans than they would have had in 10 games in the last, say, 3 years probably.
Yep.
Since the infamous Danny Bradford left town. Anyway, while we go to commercial, and you'll talk to Kelvin McKay.
Thank you.
This production is brought to you in part by Binky's Auto Clean. Owner Paul Hobart employs 3 people and specializes in complete interior and exterior cleaning and polishing of your vehicle. Binky's Auto Clean is located at number 3, 403 Industrial Road A in Cranbrook. And their motto is, how your car looks is a reflection on us. Binky's Auto Clean, a proud sponsor of community programming on Shaw Cable 11.
Like to thank Boston Pizza for their support of this production. Boston Pizza has been in business in Cranbrook since November of 1991. They have 30 full and part-time employees to serve you better. Every Tuesday night is pasta night at Boston Pizza, and their staff invites you to come on in, sit down, and enjoy. Boston Pizza, 1201 Cranbrook Street North.
We're back. We'd like to welcome Kelvin McKay, Trail Smoke Eaters coach, leader of Cranbrook Colts 2 years. Kelvin, welcome back, and we'll get right into it. Your observations in the first period.
Well, it was a great game. Both teams played really well. I thought Cranbrook definitely had the edge in play. Some great saves by Herdman. Bailey played well, and good steady defense back there.
All right, Kelvin. That's the now. Let's go to the then. You left here last year after 2 successful seasons, 70 plus wins, a RMJHL championship, a Eddie Mountain division win, I believe last year, and you headed off to Trail. Give us a little insight to what happened in Trail this year.
Well, we were in a rebuilding year this year, and we had nowhere to go but up. You know, last year was kind of a write-off for a lot of the guys, so we tried to take the positives out of that and rebuild a team that everyone could be proud of. And you know, I think we're very successful in doing that on and off ice. The kids we brought in were young kids who bought into what we were selling, bought into the program, bought into the community big time, and with over 2,000 plus fans in the playoffs, you know, I think the fans responded as well.
Yeah, you had. I was there for the game against Vernon, and there was 2,041 fans there. It had been 1,925 the night before, and Terry and I were talking about this earlier. There's probably more fans at that last game than there was in 3 years total leading up to that. We heard last year 125, 150 fans. Obviously, things turned around. Now you had a great supporting cast: Glenn Saunders, Denny McKinnon, Mike Wandon. Some other names you want to mention?
Well,
I think Kenny Caputo has been there. Yeah, he come with a building, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does. He keeps talking about it a lot. I think a lot of the credit's got to go to Sandy Santori The former mayor of Trail, who stepped on board with the marketing, and he was a jack of everything. He did everything so well, and that whole executive, there wasn't a weak link in there. Everybody had their jobs to do, and basically they did it to the best of their abilities, and it was like the product on ice. It was great, and it was hardworking, and that was the only way you could put it. It was great on and off.
Well, good. Maybe you can give us a little Reader's Digest version of what happened. You started the season out, maybe some not really great expectations, but you guys got out of the gate in a hurry, and you really never looked back. Give us a little Reader's Digest version of what went on in Trail for you guys this year.
I guess it was sort of like what we always tried to do here. We had a good, hard-working, fast-skating team. We moved the puck really, really well. It was hard to say. I think we caught a lot of people by surprise early, but by later on, we were one of the best draws on the road. I just think in a lot of ways that, the division maybe wasn't as strong as the Coastal Division, but still, we had to play the Vernons and the Penticton's, and they were the consensus, favorites in our division. And there's no question, we surprised them big time. Quinnell, Prince George were in our division. Those weren't gimme games. Maybe the Quinnell games were, but going up into Quinnell was a tough road, especially when you had to walk into PG the next night. The Coastal teams were all hard. We were fortunate to beat Surrey in our own building, but that was it was a shootout win. It was a great game, and like you said, it was a season-long building process. We moved a guy on, one of our players on to the scholarship this year, Chris Mombi. Steve McCarthy, who was a consensus all-favorite in every category in our league and in our town.
16 years old?
And he's got pro written all over him, and he's a great kid. We have 14 committed guys coming back next year. It says a lot about our program. Our program is so strong now across BC. Whereas before it may have been a have-not, now it's a have place to go. And really, we want to try to be a team that people really want to go to in the Kootenays. And I hope someday that Cranbrook and the other teams in the Rocky League, can eventually, like Bronco Horvath always wants, one major league in BC. And I really do hope that we get an opportunity to see that. And I hope that, Ron and Bronco, whatever differences they may have, if they have any, can come to some sort of agreement. Because I think it's a shame that, people here in Cranbrook can't see the Vernon Vipers or the Penticton Panthers.
Or the Trail Smoke Eaters.
You're right. But I think next year, we're going to be considered, one of the favorites, probably up there with Vernon and Penticton again, which we should be, and like I say, I can't guarantee any kind of wins or what we're going to do next year. All I can ever say is that we're going to be one of the hardest working teams in the league, and that's all any coach can really hope for, at the best of his kids.
Man, speaking of hardworking kids and somebody that's sort of dear to my heart, and kid that played hard for us, maybe you can give us a little update on former Colt Andy Oakes.
Well, Andy was a great addition to the hockey club. Andy played hard all year. Unfortunately, he got hurt. He busted up his hand in early February. Was out of the roster for 3 weeks. Got back, he hurt his knee. And I think that Andy just didn't get his timing back to where he would have really liked to have it. He gave his all every shift, every game, in the dressing room, off the ice, on the ice. I've had 3 years of him, and I'll tell you, never a bad shift in those 3 years.
All right, a little plug here. I understand you're going to be running a camp in Invermere.
Yeah, we're going to try to get a camp going in Invermere in late July. I'm not sure of the times yet. But we do want to, expose the Trail Smoke Eaters and the BC Hockey League to the rest of the Kootenays. And, you know, like the kids are obviously free to choose wherever they want to go, whether it be the Rocky Mountain League or the BC Hockey League. You know, I'm very respectful of both leagues. I think that, it takes a certain kind of player to play in the Rocky Mountain League, and it takes a certain player to play in the BC League. And, we'd like just to be a vehicle to see where, where kids would fit in and just give some a little exposure to our program, being that, as of right now, who knows what's going to happen in a month, but we are the only team in the Kootenays in the BC Hockey League. But, I'm not here to say that, one league is way better than the other. I've been on both sides, and I really felt 2 years ago when we did win this league, we gave Chilliwack a great run. But, and who's to say that an upset can't happen here? Herdman stands on his noodle. Wellito and Lega, keep playing as well as they are, and the forwards keep going. Anything can happen, and I think it's going to be Surrey that comes out of this. But everybody's writing off the Colts. I would say it'd be like us. It's until you win a game, you're on the outside looking in. And who knows? Maybe this is the year that Cranny can come up and bite somebody in the rear end.
Well, we certainly thank you for your time, Calvin. I'd ask you a question about who you're looking at. We probably don't want to give that away and put you in a bad spot. You're probably looking at everybody, right?
I'm just here watching some good hockey.
Okay, well, thanks for coming up, Calvin. We really appreciate it. And maybe you'll hang around after the game. You and I can have a chat off the air, and I'll ask you some pointed questions.
Okay.
All right. Thanks a lot, Cal. Yeah. Appreciate it. Thanks for coming up.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Calvin McKay, coach of the BC Junior Hockey League, Trail Junior Smoke Eaters, ex-Cranbrook Colts coach. We'd like to thank him for coming up. And now we'll take a little bit of time to pay some bills and head off to some of the sponsors of tonight's hockey game.
This production is brought to you by North Star Motors, located at 1816 Cranbrook Street North on the Strip in Cranbrook. North Star Motors has been in business in Cranbrook since 1967 and is operated by General Manager Derek Spring. North Star Motors employs a staff of friendly and courteous personnel who are always there to assist you. North Star specializes in new and used vehicles and quality auto parts. They also offer a wide range of automotive services from vehicle tune-ups to repairs, as well as a state-of-the-art paint bay where quality workmanship is guaranteed. North Star Motors is a proud sponsor of community programming on Shaw Cable 11. North Star Motors is your number one GM dealer in the Kootenays.
Well, we're back. First intermission. Let's have a summary.
Well, Cranbrook opened the scoring. Morgan Bailey from Brad Patterson, 2:28, breakaway pass, and it was just straight second effort, though, I think. A great effort by Wade Dubas to stop the puck. A second effort by Morgan Bailey, and there's one thing, kids watching. They say that all the time, kids watching. Morgan didn't let him take himself out of play by skating behind the net. He stopped and banged away at the rebound, knocked it in.
Well, let's clear up one thing right now, too. We often talk up here, at least I do, I'll take credit for that, about players going to the net after the whistle and whapping the goaltender. Now, Bailey went to the net, shot the puck, and as you just mentioned, stayed right on the puck. A good second effort by hitting Dublowitz, and a good goal. Now, there's a 1 or 2 second delay there, and if you hit the puck too late, then you're going to cause some trouble. But Bailey, entirely within his rights on that play.
Oh, yeah, and I think, Morgan in the last couple of games has certainly come on. I think he was sort of conspicuous by his absence the last 4 or 5 games, and maybe Bobby Nels had something to say to him, but he's certainly, Morgan, believe it or not, is one of the fastest skating guys in this league.
I believe it.
But he very rarely chooses to show it, and tonight, 2 or 3 times he showed how quick he is by getting into the open and taking a pass, and one thing is being quick. We've seen Dale Rushkin from Kimberley. He's really quick, but he never seems to have the puck with him.
Well, you got to go the right way.
Yeah.
Anyway, who else scored?
So then Dave Bolito, on a good effort along the boards, scared Ben Tornberger and Brad Kennedy out of year's growth just by standing there, skated along, fed Mike Fischel, who gave a return pass, and Mike deposited in the empty net. That was at 6:44. And then a bit of a turnover. It was a bit of a turnover. Jeff Oldenburger just never got to the puck. Brad Bolger found himself out in the wide open, and the assist on that went to Aaron Kowalski. Bolger just rifled in the top of the net, and actually it had been stopped. The first pass out was stopped by Sean Herdman, and Jeff Oldenburger was still behind the net when the shot came. So and that happened at 13:17 of the first period.
And the shots on goal.
Shots on goal. Wade Dubowitz made 15 saves, and Sean Herdman made 9.
And how many penalties? What a surprise.
Well, there were 3 penalties in that period total. And 2 of them came on one play. Mike Fischel whacking somebody in the noodle, and who was having to have a hold of his stick. And that was Trevor Demoskoff, that didn't want to let, felt that it was unfair for Fischel to play with a stick the way he hits.
Well, we've mentioned the top goaltenders. Why don't you go over the top scorers for the playoffs? Why are you busy? Why are you not?
No, I'm fine.
You're fine?
Okay. I was writing down your recipe for beef stroganoff.
Well, while you're at it, get the attendance. But Dustin Kersey had a great series for Nelson. Just as he had a regular season.
I think Dustin got, he was probably the only bright light for Nelson, but he was their offense, and, the Colts, I don't know if they keyed on him, but they made sure that he didn't kill him, and just as we were talking about tonight, with Dave Bolito, you don't want one guy to kill you. Cranbrook didn't let Dustin Kersey kill him, but Dustin was leading the playoffs with 17 points.
And Derek Stewart for Kimberly also showed up. He, very quick hands.
That was
Derek
the guy
Stewart.
That killed Cranbrook.
Yep.
That was one guy killing Cranbrook.
Yep.
If you ask anybody here who watched that series, it was Derek Stewart and Cam Dodd.
Yep.
But Derek Stewart was had a mediocre season, being a returning vet, stepped up in the playoffs and got Kimberly on, past the team that they maybe weren't supposed to be, and in against Fernie.
And Cam Dodd won the Rookie of the Year and the MVP for the Kimberly Dynamiters Town Hockey Team this year as they finished their season on a pretty good note compared to what they were like at Christmas time. Well, Dustin Kersey and Derek Stewart from 2 losing teams. That says something. There's a whole list of Colts as we go down from Brooke, Fordham, Spencer, McLeod.
And Dan Tall from Creston.
And he came on great in the second half of the year for Creston.
Well, Robbie Brooke jumped himself right up into it with a 5-point night the other night. He now has 12 goals and 10 assists. 10 goals and 7 assists for 17 points. But you're right, I think this is the strength. And here's maybe the reason why Kimberly and Nelson are off the side, is that they've got one guy in the top 10.
And nobody else
got 3 or 4 apiece. So a balanced scoring, not depending on one guy. And when one guy got shut down, the other lines are taking it on. And Lee Spencer led the league in points. You expect him to be up there. I think Mike Fordham would have led him if he hadn't had that break around Christmas time, the illness in his family. And then Kelly McLeod, just a good, hard-working forward. I think Kelly's only got 2 or 3 goals, but he's got a baker's dozen of assists. Maybe just a dozen.
We start the second period. Colts lead 2-1, and Scott Lega gets the puck in deep right off the bat. Ford is back against Spencer. Steckman on the loose puck. Scott at the point will wrist it at the net. Deflected. The score! Lee Spencer. 3-1.
But this is, I don't want to actually going to give Cranbrook some credit, but they weren't trying to get that puck. Jeff Stepman, but Freddie didn't hit anybody. They were slow getting on the puck. The forwards are slow coming back, and nobody helped out. This comes back to Jeff Scott on the point. He directs the puck on the net. Norrie gets knocked down. Ford has his stick lifted, and Lee Spencer shovels it in.
Well, Wade Dibowitz had an average of 2.6 coming into this game, so obviously it was around 2 before the first game. The Colts got 5 goals in the first game, and they've got 3 goals in less than 21 minutes in the second game, so his average is going to take a beating against the Colts. Bolito back, he comes up with the puck, he's up against the glass, he one-hands the puck, Redman was on him. Down the ice, 2 Colts chase it. Dibowitz rings the boards, Brooke will be there. His body gets away from a check. Thornburg up with Kennedy, who just gives it to Wolito. Stromquist has the puck go between his legs, and here's DeMoskov, he'll dump the puck in. Oldenburger's back, throws the puck the other way. Brooke has it in his skates, flips it to Maltman. Maltman and McLeod, as Maltman wants a change, DeMoskov is back for the Dynamiters. Thornburg tied up by Slodovnik, who ends up with the puck. DeMoskov slow to go to him. The Ghost Riders start away. 3 of them to center against 3 Colts. A long shot by Redman, and that's way wide. Kennedy still on the ice and still not doing much as Fischel starts away. In deep is Brandvold for the Ghost Riders, run by Sadovnik, who gets a piece of him. Sadovnik whaps at the loose puck and misses that. 0-for-2 on hits. Here come the Ghost Riders. Over the line is Kennedy into the slot. And he's tracked down by Sadovnik, who takes a puck away. McGowan, lots of time, right in front, and just misses. The puck was just behind Kennedy. Sadovnik down the ice, and Kennedy takes a run at him. As the Colts get called for icing with 2 minutes and 4 seconds gone in the second period, 3-1 Colts.
About a 2 minute shift for Matt Kennedy. But they did have the right play. Nick McGowan had the right play there on Sean Herdman. Herdy comes out and challenges better than any goaltender in the league, and he doesn't care if he comes out 10, 15, 20 feet. He'll come out and challenge you to beat him. And McGowan held onto the puck and then slid across back door on him, but Brad Kennedy was probably too tired to get a stick on it after that 2 minute shift.
Well, McGowan made a good play, because if you're going to beat Herdman from where McGowan was, that's the way to do it. And the pass was close, but not close enough. Back to the point and on the line, Ford flips it. It goes through the crease. Corey Becker's there. Colts, Letosky tracked down, gets the puck to the line. It doesn't get out as Zimmerman can't get away. Here's Ford, wrists it. Herdman, an easy save. Becker's check. Jacobek in the slot, throws it in the Ghost Riders defense, forced to back up. Here comes Patterson over the line, into the slot. Jacobek down. Off the post is Jacobek's shot. As Dibowitz was down and beaten. Letosky in the corner. Ford will go after him. Can't control him. Patterson ends up with the puck. Colt. Patterson back to Jacobek. Now he'll go against Baldwin. Becker at the point, wrists it, it bounces. Letosky is hacked. He has the puck behind the net, right in front. Jacobek couldn't get a good shot. Becker's going to be bodied against the boards. That was a bad hit. And now a penalty. Well, that's a bad hit on Corey Becker. I don't know if we can get a look at that.
I don't think the penalties for that. There's Ford and Jacobek, I think, from in front of the net.
Corey Becker's lucky. If we get a shot at this.
And he's got a bad shoulder already, Terry.
And we'll look at this.
Right here.
Now there, what you mentioned before, that could have been charging, hitting from behind, roughing, anything, because he took 3 steps.
And he came off the bench looking for him.
And one more time, look at this. And all he had to do was cut in front of him, and he hits him from behind. Here's Scott Lega, low shot. Dibowitz deflects it to the corner. Stromkus Can't get away from Spencer, who has the puck. Kennedy's in. So you got offsetting Miners. Kennedy still in a zone. Here's Scott at the point. Can't get it in deep. Three Ghost Riders go right by. Here's Fordham with Steckman loose. Right in front. Steckman couldn't get a stick on it. Fordham behind the net into the slot. Is Spencer, and he gives it away. Here come the Ghost Riders, three of them to center. Thornburg, Kennedy on the side. Thornburg just gives it to Jeff Scott. Granville rips one. And Herdman, the save. Here they come the other way. Here's Fordham with Spencer, offside. And Mike Fordham has been operating in second gear himself this first two periods, Rocky.
Now there's one of those ones, that drop pass, Terry, that kills everybody in the rink that's heading north, because you know what's going to happen. You know, if that puck isn't right on the guy's stick, then the turnover that occurs puts all your team in jeopardy. And once again, Brad Kennedy, dead last guy, getting back into his own zone.
Well, the Ghost Riders, Rocky, seem to me to be throwing the puck to a spot rather than to their own sticks. They've had the Colts defense beat bad several times and have just thrown the puck right to them. Wolito's at center. Puck is in a Ghost Rider zone momentarily and right back in. Here they come again. Branvold off the boards this time. It's tipped off of Oldenburger's stick. Wolito goes back. He'll be chased by Korkal. On the puck is Bohm. Porter's loose in the slot. Bohm centers it. Here's McGowan at the point. He'll look and then shoot it. Herdman's down. Two shots. Herdman out. And there's the difference between the Colts' third goal and a Ghost Riders. The Colts strong in front of Herdman.
Here's the difference here. You watch Jeff Oldenburger get a hold of Ryan Porter and make sure he can't get no rebound. Right here. He's got the stick on him. No way. He's got his leg between his legs. Dave Wolito has got to hold the boom. And nobody's going to get that rebound. Now, that's the difference played against big, strong defensemen.
Who want to be.
You can't let yourself get tied up. Ryan Porter went in there and tried to stand in front. You know, and you've got to be, once you go in there, you've got to be mobile and moving around. And as soon as he stops skating, Jeff Oldenburger put that big stick and that big leg on him. And he's out of the play.
Korkal against McLeod. And Korkal gets tossed, so does McLeod. Baldwin now against Bohm. McGowan is right behind Bohm, but McLeod ends up with a puck checked by Korkal. Four Korkal fans on the first pass, and then he's nailed against the boards. McLeod trying to get out with one hand on his stick. Brooks starts away. Puck comes to Branvold, the long pass by Bohm and by Wolito. Porter's in. The puck comes to the other side where Brooks is, into the slot, and out over the line, Ghost Riders. Bohm and McLeod. Now Bohm has it again. A long pass right on Oldenburger's stick. Ghost Riders, a lot of passes on the Colts stick. Dublowitz, a save on Oldenburger's hard shot from the line. Bohm on the side. Porter breaking. The puck is off his stick. Scott Legg is back. And the Ghost Riders really guilty again. It doesn't matter what line it seems. They're staying on the ice for a long time. McGowan in trouble against Fischel. Branvold and Fischel body. Moon misses his check. Scott Legge in the slot. Wrists it. Dumoulin is down. And of course, Fischel's there. Taking a hack at him. Dennis Moon now. And we get a scrum. Fischel and Branvold. But Lazon and LaValle, the two linesmen, are in. And there'll
Let's
be penalties here.
That's where Glenn Brown's got to take control. Now, we talked about going to the net after the whistle. Now, and Glenn Brown could solve all this right now by giving Mike Fischel 4 minutes and Branvold two. Now, Branvold deserved a two, and Mike deserved two, but it's not Mike. It's anybody. You don't want to see that. That's going to start something that's unnecessary. Now, the whistle's gone. Some guy whacks the goaltender to start something.
Well, what Dublowitz is doing in the scrum there is a silly thing. But I agree with 100%. We've said it many times here. The guy goes to the net should always get four. after the whistle, and the guy who comes to the goaltender's rest, you should get two.
Well, I'm not, you know, Terry, the one thing I take exception with this is two guys fighting.
Well,
after the whistle, get penalties after the whistle. Well, you can whack the goaltender all you want.
Sadovnik through Stekman. Ford is back. On the side is Lega, away from a check. Two Colts over the line. There's four Ghost Riders. Lega shot off the blocker. Dennis Moon is checked. Babcock going nowhere against Sladovnik, who has the puck. Falling, gets it at the net. Stekman. Baldwin pushes him against the boards. Dennis Moon against Baldwin. Stekman in the slot, a backhander. Dulowitz is down. Another shot by Stekman. Sladovnik in front. And it looks like he messed up Aaron Kowalski's hair. Some of the Ghost Riders fell in a big bucket of bleach head first, right?
Well, we'll see what the penalties are here, but anybody was within 5 feet of that net could have taken a penalty, so for sure, I think Baldwin, for sure Dennis Moon, and I would say that Glenn Brown missed Kowalski.
Well, in front
and Sladovnik, and we can see Kowalski and Sladovnik off to the left. There's one punch by Sladovnik, there's two. I think Moon Kowalski's getting it. And Moon, Baldwin, Kowalski, and Sladovnik. That's a horrible trade for Fernie. But that's what those guys are there to do from Cranbrook.
So a face-off in the Ghost Rider zone, Jacob Eck against Hofstrand. Valley drops the puck and comes out over the line. Corey Becker will drill it right back in off the glass. And back in his own zone, Demoskov falls down. Strongquist flips it right to Corey Becker. He'll do the same thing. This time off the end boards, Hofstrand turns away from Patterson. A pass to Zimmerman at center. Won't get by Walito. Demoskov in again. Two Colts after him. Can't corral him. Zimmerman on the boards, flips it. Open ice, Ghost Riders, two of them. Kevin Martin just misses getting around Scott Lega. Lilani Lutowski is grabbed. The puck comes to Lega. His pass by Patterson, and the Colts get called for icing. Well, Dennis Moon was guilty earlier in the year of taking a lot of penalties per shift, but he's kept himself in control in the playoffs. And you know, he's got 8 minutes in penalties, but I'll guarantee you he gets eight hits a shift.
Well, that whole line is there for a reason. They're instigators. They're the fourth line. In tight games, they don't play a lot. Bobby's got a two-goal lead, and he's going to send those guys out to agitate. And
they do. Spencer with Stekman. Over the line is Spencer. Puck is bouncing, and he couldn't get control. Stekman to the corner, is bodied. Kennedy is in. Has it taken away from him to Moskov. Away from Fordham, and off the glass and down the ice.
Here's the, you know, and maybe I'm on a bit of a Kennedy tear tonight, but, you know, I watched him last year, and he's 100% different player this year.
Right.
You know, you watch now. He'll go to a guy. If he doesn't get the puck, he goes for a 5-minute skate out to center. That's why he can stay so long, because he doesn't work at all. He's just out for a skate, and the only place he works is from the blue line in the other team's zone.
Well, here he faces the captain, Lee Spencer, who beat him by 1 point in the regular season in scoring for the last good couple of weeks. Fordham comes in against Kennedy and beats him. Oldenburger's wrister, Dublowitz is down. And Ford's gonna get a slash. Oh, that's a bad call. I think that's a bad call. He let a bad hit on Becker go, and he let a bad hit on a Ghost Rider go down on the other end, both from behind. And Chris Ford just lays his stick on Fordham's arms and gets 2 minutes. But I guess what he's doing here, Rocky, is trying to take control. And it never fails. He let two hits from behind go, or two marginal hits go. That always gets the players angry, and then he has to straighten the game out again.
He didn't give Mike Fischel any time for slashing. No, slashing did, but it's, I'm glad I don't pay to these games, because I couldn't stand to watch Glenn Brown. I'm glad this is free. He does this to me game in, game out. Makes two good calls and then makes a call and that has everybody perplexed.
Here comes Wolito. Over the line.
There's
Fordham's
one.
In. Back to the point. Spencer is there. Wrists it at the net. Fordham can't get the puck to Wolito. Lega and Spencer at the points. Wolito, Fordham, and Steckman. All within 1 foot of the end boards. 12:03 left in the second period. 3-1 Colts on goals by Spencer, Wolito, and Morgan Bailey. Brad Bolger has a goal for the Ghost Riders. Spencer against Hofstrand, who seems to take a lot of faceoffs in his own zone. Colt Steckman is in to tip the puck to Wolito. On the side is Fordham. The Colts trying to get something going on the power play. Wolito at the line, right on the line. Dublowitz, an easy save. Lega kicks and misses. Wolito on the line again, saves it. Stromquist doesn't get it out against Lega this time. Lega in deep. Stromquist sort of challenges him. Spencer at the point, he'll shoot it, and that's deflected wide. Spencer chases it to the other side. Fordham behind the net. Lega going to the net. The puck is in his skates. Zimmerman ahead to Hofstrand, and Spencer with 45 seconds left in the power play starts away. Kennedy hacks him. Spencer over the line against Brandvold. A pass intended for Fordham ends up back on his own stick. Fordham has it this time. Can't center it once. Fordham playing with it in a corner. Another bad pass, and Brad Kennedy gets it just to the line. Oldenburger in a bit of difficulty. The Colts get away with too many men. Thornburg over the line. Oldenburger will track him down. And the puck ends up in the corner with 3 seconds. And the power play, and the Colts really don't get anything of significance. Brooke has a puck go over his stick. Brandvold back, off the boards, down the ice, no icing. Thornburg, one of the few Ghost Riders to show any speed tonight, and then falls. Maltman on the side, leaves it for McLeod. McLeod, a slow dump in. McGowan will go back off the boards. Redmond can't get out. McLeod to Brooke. Intended for Maltman, is deflected. Kennedy in deep, loses it to McLeod. McGowan saves him. And then his pass ends up back in his stick. McGowan will try the other side as McLeod is upended by Brandvold. McGowan to Redmond. Redmond with Thornburg behind him. Redmond against Wolito, who ties him up. Puck goes to the corner. Jeff Scott. The puck is in Thornburg's skates. He didn't know it. Brandvold at the point. Just about gave it away. Wolito, long pass to Jacobek, and he falls to get away from a check. Here comes Brandvold. A wrestler. A good save by Herdman with the pads. And he's made a lot of saves to the pads tonight. To Moskov. Get the puck in deep enough, gets given back. And here comes Jeff Scott with Jacobek. Scott over the line. Dublowitz is down, a loose puck. Kennedy. A long backhand pass intended for Thornburg. And Brad Patterson takes him out of the play. Redmond. Checked by Jacobek. Thornburg right against Jacobek. Patterson on the side, flips the puck to center. Demoskov on the other side it goes. Jeff Scott will just shoot it down. Well, won't get it down. Ooh, now there's a tough call. Stromquist and Jacobek at center jostle. That was a close play at the line.
Well, there's been a few close plays, but Freddie doesn't want to to leave a man high, Terry. They get going to the net, and they get all three guys going to the net, and as a result, they get all three guys trapped. And, you know, Wade Dublowitz has had to stand on his head for two periods to keep this game even close. And even with the three guys going to the net, they don't really go to the net. They just go, they head in that direction, and then they all peel off, and there's no stopping and starting and getting back in the play. It's going for a great big long skate out of the corner and try and take themselves like 150 feet away from the play.
Slodovnik shoots a puck down the ice, and that's icing. Well, this line has one goal in mind. Get the puck ahead to the other team's end. They don't care how they do it, and then go chase it.
Well, you know, it's literally that, you know, they'll put it in their lunch bucket and carry it down, and they don't care how it goes in. You know one thing is that Jeremy Slodovnik come across the line from Detroit with his gun loaded.
Dennis Moon now in the face-off circle against Korkle. Becker is back. Away from a check. On the other side is Fischel. Waits and waits and is bodied by Korkle. But Dennis Moon's going to get an elbowing penalty. Now we've got a discussion, the linesman as well. What's going on here? What could they be talking about?
I'm trying to figure out why he blew the whistle.
Well, Jeff Scott had complete control of the puck.
Did Jeff Scott touch it as he was falling down?
He had complete control of the puck in his skates as he was falling down. And here's a replay here. Oh, he did touch it with his stick and then his skates. Well,
how come they don't blow the whistle when it hits the goaltender in the skate?
So the Colts get a penalty. And the Ghost Riders in a little bit of need here to get something offensively, some offensive control in the cold zone. As we have seen very little of that from that tonight. If they had some control and made three or four or five good passes, every good pass would have ended up with a good scoring chance. Instead, they've just given the Colts the puck. And they have taken away as many chances from themselves as the Colts have.
Here, this is a bit of a bonus. I don't know why it took so long to call a penalty, but it gives Mike Vandekamp a chance to set up the power play. But now they're asking Glenn Brown, and I don't know if Glenn's going to help set up the power play or not.
Well, they got seven guys talking to him. Looks like the Pied Piper.
Well, I don't know what, all you got to get out of it. Well, you're not even going to get that out of it.
Now the face-off.
Brian Lezon is calling it now.
Well,
they should give Brian Lezon the referee stripes. He tries to run the game, and he's blowing the whistle when the puck's still in the rink.
Well, Branvold and Baldwin on the points. Kennedy. Thornburg. And Korkle on the power play. Baldwin. Pass off Branvold's stick. Spencer will chase Baldwin. Dublowitz leaves it for Baldwin. Spencer with the hook out. Baldwin gets away from the hook, and they don't get by Jeff Oldenburger, who was standing still but stopped the puck. Branvold now. They try to dump him. On the other side is Kennedy. He loses the puck to Wolito. Here's Thornburg. Back to the point is Baldwin. Korkle's in front with Oldenburger. Branvold scores! Dan Thornburg. 3-2. And Thornburg gets his fifth goal of the playoffs and 17th point. That's got to be classic.
I'd like to have another look at this. I think Brad Kennedy got this off the shot here. We'll see. I think it's Thornburg shoots it.
Well, it went off Wolito's stick.
Oh, it was Wolito's stick.
Let's have another look at that if we can, but Dave Wolito tips the puck. It was a bad angle shot. And Wolito gets a stick on it, which he should. And it changes direction
right
just enough.
goes back to Thornburg, Hank, on the side. Yep.
Demoskov, as the Ghost Riders get back in this again. 3-2. Well, Rocky, the Ghost Riders, from what I've seen, we'll get to that in a minute. Here's McLeod and Brooke. Over the line, Brooke. The puck is behind him, and he throws it at the net. Demoskov won't get away from Maltman. McLeod, to Brooke, he misses. Ghost Riders back. Here comes Thornburg with Kennedy and Redmond, who stays with McLeod. Kennedy in deep against Scott. Thornburg behind the net. Kennedy, a wraparound off the chest of Herdman. Back to the point, Demoskov, right on the line. Jeff Scott knocks it down and then shoots it into McLeod's equipment. McLeod into the corner, and the Colts on a change. Demoskov takes his time to center. Redmond stopped by Walido and Patterson up with the puck. He just shovels it to Demoskov, who rips it off the boards down the ice. Well, Rocky, I think off the first game, the Ghost Riders didn't play well. And the first 20 minutes of the first period and 13 more minutes, 27 seconds of the second, they've had about three players show a lot of effort. The rest are just floating the way I feel. They're not playing well at all, and they're still only turning 3-2. If they start to play, they could be in the series.
Well, this is what Bobby Hank was afraid of, and he said, you know, is that he didn't have a lot of guys going. Fernie had less. You know, tonight it's just about even.
Ghost Riders, Bolger won't get out. Patterson to Letosky with Jacobek. Here's Jacobek. He didn't have a stick on the ice. Ford tied up by Jacobek in a headlock. Patterson from the side, a backhander, weak and wide. Jacobek spins. Ford knocks him down and then knocks Patterson down. Ghost Riders will start away. Bolger loose on the side is Babcock. He's got to step on Walido and doesn't take advantage of it. Baldwin in. Patterson on the back check, and Baldwin slides a shot just wide. 3-on-2 the other way. Jacobek makes it a 3-on-4. Centering pass tipped by Dubowitz to the corner. Walido behind the net is Letosky. Back to the Walido. A bouncing puck in the slot. Steckman couldn't get it to the net. Lega to Letosky, bodied by Ford for the third time this shift. Steckman spins away from a check and then shovels the puck with Bolger. Out for the Ghost Riders. Babcock wants no part of Scott Lega. In is Bolger. Babcock with the puck, back to the point, but he puts it right on Steckman's stick. Brandvold was wide open. Here's Steckman. Two deeks around McGowan, a shot right on Spencer, Fordham! Dubowitz is there. And Dubowitz starts to come up big.
Well, here's the thing, Terry, I don't know, how do you expect to win games when one of your leading scorers, Brandon Babcock, he's got the legs and he's got the hands, but he don't have the heart. You know, he's got to step on Dave Bolino, and he knows if he goes to the net, he's going to get whacked. He's there. He's got 9 goals and 3 assists, and I'll guarantee you, nobody the size of Oldenburger, Walido, or Scott Lega, and he did the same thing against Lega, threw a 5 or 10 pounds of snow just to make sure he didn't get hit. And that's what drives coaches crazy, Terry, is guys that look like they're playing hard but are killing you out there.
Walido's back. He'll be chased by Hofstrand. Walido off the boards to Fordham with Spencer. And the Colts starting to not throw the puck ahead. And Fordham is run by McGowan, who seems to be quite willing to be physical. Spencer out of the corner. Look at this. A backhander. Dubois is down. 2 shots at it. And Dubois is there again. We don't have any information on Nick McGowan. He's an affiliated player, but he has been very physical tonight and not afraid to challenge any Colt.
Well, he made a bad play in the first Terry, but I got to give him credit. He's come back and played hard. There's a horrible play by Mike Hofstrand and Kevin Martin. Now, a horrible play down in the far end. You got a back check coming back through the middle, and Fernie wants to make a big turn of the boards, and by the time they get back into the play, it's way too late. Now, and there they left their defenseman all alone.
Corey Becker just misses as Dubowitz gets a piece of it. Becker will get another chance, wrists it, doesn't get anywhere. Zimmerman to the side. the captain, going the wrong way. Behind the net is Demoskov. He's in some trouble. Maltman centers it. Dubowitz is down.
They got to get this line off there. Chad Zimmerman's your captain. He doesn't want to turn and go against Wolito, so he throws the puck back on his forehand. Kevin Martin doesn't want to hit anybody. Mike Hofstrand doesn't cover his check. No, I mean, that's why that puck ends up in your net. This is the difference with Cranbrook, Terry. They got 3-4 lines that don't mind mucking it out, playing it up and down, whichever style you want to play. And I'll guarantee you, those guys waltzed through their last playoff round against Kimberly without getting hit, without getting touched. And now they're in tough here, and you know, it's playoff hockey. You got to take a shot hit now and again.
Jeff Scott has passed to the corner. Maltman pass doesn't get to the center. Scott will get another chance. Fans on it. A third chance. Fans again. Maltman in the slot. Right at the net. And Demoskov gets a stick on it. Bolger back the other way. Loses the puck. Stefan Stromquist. Tracked down by McLeod. Maltman pass to Brooke. He'll chip it to the corner. And there. Ghost Riders take over. Kowalski gets it to center. Right back in. Demoskov. Brooke is right on him. How did that happen?
Right off one of the metal bars.
How could Brook be over the line? How could he get that far?
Well, you can outside. See, you know, I think, Terry, you see the difference in Cranbrook here now, and that's why I say they keep the teams in the game. They don't get that same effort 3 and 4 and 5 shifts in a row. You know, if they did that, you know, Dublowitz would be digging the puck out of his net 4 or 5 more times. But what happens is they'll come out and they'll get 2 shifts like that or 3, and then they'll have 3 where they don't do it. And it either keeps the team back in the game or gives the other team a little bit of momentum.
Well, 3:44 left in the second. Ghost Riders, Baldwin on the other side. Thornburg and Baldwin off the boards. Repin looking for Kennedy, who is at center ice, and is knocked down by Patterson. Ford in trouble against Slodovnik. As Patterson goes on the left wing with Jacobek and Slodovnik. Redmond can't get out. Slodovnik's going to run him and push him against the boards and get a whistle. A good effort there against 2 Ghost Riders.
Well, I think Richard Neal, who referees on Thursday nights, and is a blood relation to Ray Charles, would have called that one interference on Brad Kennedy.
Wolito's shot doesn't get to the net. Fordham to the corner. Ford on the other side. Steckman in. Ford has the puck in his skates and is in difficulty against Steckman. Spun around. Kennedy and Spencer. Kennedy lets him go. The puck ends up. Redmond can't get it ahead. And boy, the Ghost Riders in real difficulty getting the puck to somebody open on their own team. Spencer with lots of time. A long pass, Fordham. He'll shoot it right in. Dublowitz is down and cuts the angle. Ford is bodied by Steckman. Here's Wolito. He'll shoot it. Deflected. Dublowitz, it goes off his mask. 3-on-2. Kennedy to Thornburg. Nobody goes to the net. Steckman back checking, makes it a 3-on-3. A pass across, and Kennedy. Now there's not a great play by Kennedy. He hasn't done anything all night. Then he goes in and he's going to get Dave Wolito mad at him.
Well, and you know, there's another one. Glenn Brown's standing there watching it. And what, you know, and Dave Wolito could wreak havoc out there. You know, and Bobby does. They don't need to lose him. But, you know, when you got a guy that plays a game like Dave does, that just plays hard and bangs. You know, he had a chance over here to run a guy face first into the glass, and he just come up, bumped him, made sure the puck didn't come out. You know, and then to let Kennedy come behind him and spear him like that and just shake your head, you should shake your head, bro.
He's lucky to be able to shake his head. He's lucky it's not rattling around on the ice somewhere. Here comes Babcock, wrists it over top of the net, deflected. Jeff Scott gets it out of trouble to the corner. McGowan over the line, and it'll be a delayed offside. Scott Lega. He'll be chased by Bolger, who's had a good period, or almost 2 periods now. McLeod. That'll be icing, unless Dublowitz has to play it, and does. Around the board, Scott in against Bolger. Bolger outmuscles him. A long pass over Willito's stick and a good second effort there. Back. Babcock now against McLeod, and Babcock doesn't. Kowalski took a run there, McLeod and missed. Here's Branville. Gives it right to Jeremy Slodovnik. It has been a comedy of errors at times. Jacobek pins McGowan on the side now. Ghost Riders. Kevin Martin. A foot pass on the other side. Branvold on the rush. Babcock behind him. Branvold around Willito. There's a Mack truck going around a logging truck. There's another horrible change. This is Oldenburger. Look at this. Right in. Dubowitz owns him. Patterson's in. Great save by Dubowitz. A great pass by Jacobek. Oldenburger's long reach and Dubowitz owns him. Well, that was fun.
Another horrible change by Fernie. And here, what's even worse is Zimmerman goes for a skate by the net. The puck was still loose. Intensity, Kerry.
Well, another look at that. Jeff Oldenburger still looking for his first goal in the playoffs. That's a great pass by Jacobek, though. And Dubowitz. Great save. 41 seconds left in the second period. Tomaskov on this side. Kevin Martin on the Zimmerman stick. Back to Martin. Two passes in a row. Martin shoots it. And I think that hit Herdman's shoulder or his mask and goes into the crowd. And that was a good shot.
I think I hit him in the noodle. But Sean was, it's unusual for Sean, Terry. If we get a look at this, he's down really early here. We switched to the far camera, and it hit him. Well, that's why he was down.
Yeah, I'm wondering, he got hit by a bullet. 28 seconds left to face off in the cold zone, and the Dynamiters get three passes in a row.
Which was about 2 weeks ago, and the Ghost Riders get three right here.
I guess they did, didn't they? The Ghost Riders. Why does that happen? Anyway. Spencer and Zimmerman in the face-off circle. Zimmerman wins a draw, and it's a false start for 1 second gone.
Jason Cavan looks like he's going to jump out of the booth if Fernie scores here. But that would be like a leaf falling out of a tree for that build.
He's got nothing to stop from floating to the ground. Now Michael Hofstrand in against Spencer. And I believe they played with each other in Grand Prairie. Or the Hofstrand play in Fort St. George. Now Hofstrand against Steckman. Spencer to the corner. Willito right in front, and Herdman had to be a little alert after falling asleep momentarily. A long pass intended for Spencer. Demoskov is back with 15 seconds left. Stromquist, a good play. Here's trouble. In is Kevin Martin. Scotch! Great save by Herdman on Chad Zimmerman. Fordham's back with 2 seconds, and that'll be it. Jeff Scott, a good play to get back on the back check, and Chad Zimmerman had all sorts of net to shoot at and didn't bear down. And let's have a look at that if we can. At the start of the third period, needless to say, an important period for the Fernie Ghost Riders.
Well, I think it's important both ways, obviously, Terry. I mean, I don't think it's any less important for Cranbrook. You know, they took away home ice advantage from Fernie in this series by winning Thursday night. And now, if they lose tonight, you know, they're right back where they started again. You know, and then it's a best of five with Fernie holding the home ice advantage. Now, and maybe it's the disadvantage. They get 4 games in Fernie's barn, and Fernie to get 3 here. I don't know, I think it's very important for Cranbrook to come out. And they started the second period, you know, like I thought they were going to start the game, and ended up 17 seconds in, they got a goal. That was all the scoring until 12:24 when Ben Tornberg took a shot at the net, and it deflected off Dave Willito's stick, dropped down on the ice, and kept Fernie in the game now, 3-2.
Gary Davidson said the same thing about the BC Junior Hockey League, as you said, and you've seen them this year, and the games that I've seen in the last 4 or 5 years, which numbers maybe 10 or 12, I think, it's faster, the puck moves faster, no doubt about that. A little more skilled, probably, at the end, on some of the better teams. This league is more physical and less stick work.
Well, I thought
that more stick work, I left that out, didn't I?
Yeah. Actually, an ex-Colt, Darren Ibbotson, stopped by. I was talking with him today, and he's been watching the AJ play, and all the teams had one comment about Grand Prairie. They had to have played in the Rocky League just because of how much stick work that they brought to each and every game. Now, it's got them to the, I believe, the semifinals.
The semis against Calgary, they were down 2-1.
Against Calgary, and I think they're down 3-1. Fort McMurray and...
anyway, what about
Sherwood Park, 2-2. Sorry?
What about Grand Prairie?
Well, Grand Prairie, the talk was is that they've got so many players that played years in the Rocky League that it's all stick work. But it's been successful for them.
Well, a couple of players that played well in this league, they're still playing well in the playoffs against Calgary. But let's get on to this game. Ford off the board for the Ghost Riders, and it's right back to his partner, Baldwin. Baldwin tries the other side. Oldenburger fans on the puck, and Dave Oleta will go back in the lake at the back of the net, gives it to Babcock, who won't get by Oldenburger. Steckman behind the net to Fordham. Fordham throws it to nobody in particular. Demoskov. Now, a long pass. Kennedy is in. Rolito chases him. Kennedy loses the puck and scores himself. And Rolito gives Kowalski a whack. Let's have a look at that. Now, you mentioned Brad Kennedy.
And there's Dave Rolito.
His lack of speed.
Well, here he took a breakaway pass. When goes in, and now just that big stick right here, we'll see it. Of Dave Oleto gets in between his arm, the puck goes 10 feet wide. Brad Kennedy is upset, he runs over Herdman, then he knocks the net off. And then the puck comes out front, and Aaron Kowalski shoots it in the net. Oleto gives him a chop, and then he shoots the puck down, all the way down the ice.
Well, the only knock against Oleto, if there is one, is his lack of foot speed, and he caught Brad Kennedy. Here's Demoskov. He'll shoot the puck and it's deflected just wide. Kennedy in, centers it, Lega's there. 3-on-2, Lega, long, high shot over top of the net. Maltman going to the puck. Knocked down by Demoskov. McLeod is in. There's a loose stick. It's Maltman's. McLeod has the puck and the Colts do a good job. Here's Brook behind the net. He'll try to center it. Comes out in front. Maltman! Great save by Dibowitz. The puck is loose. McCall gets whapped. Great save by Dibowitz. And
great
a quick
save.
Whistle.
But once again, it gets into that. It's a poor defensive zone coverage, Terry. That puck came loose, and Robbie Brook beats Stefan Stromquist to the puck. And Stromquist is a step slow getting in behind the net, and he's allowed to walk out in front and tries to jam.
And there will be penalties.
I just think that like double roughing here.
Well, that's a good call.
But it's that you got to have confidence that you're as good as that guy out there, or you can't be out on the ice. And reacting is not the way to win hockey games.
Well, I know that Glenn Brown isn't your favorite ref, but a lot of the games that I have seen in the BC Junior, they're using referees, young referees on their way up, and yes, it's great to have them on their way. But we've got a lot of veteran referees in this league who referee the game, have a much greater feel for the game than a lot of the young, inexperienced referees in the BC Junior.
Well, I think my beef with Glenn Brown, Terry, is the stuff, not so much the stuff he calls, is the stuff he doesn't call. And that's what
here's Becker, a high shot.
Takes the game out of, lets that game get out of control.
Well, 3 years ago, we said he called too much, which he did. Puck is loose. Jacobek is a stick grabbed, and Brandvold finds Zimmerman. Zimmerman gives it right to Patterson. Now boy, the Ghost Riders have given the puck away countless times. Becker loses it. Ghost Riders can't take advantage. Kevin Martin away from Letoski. Flips the puck in. Hofstra will chase Lolito and Becker on the other side. A long pass behind Letoski. Over the line, Ford does a good job against Letoski. Jacobek is the third player. And Dimlewicz grabs a hold and hangs on. And the Ghost Riders really slow in all three periods in the first 4 or 5 minutes in their own zone.
Well, the other thing is when they get back into their own zone, they invariably leave Cranbrook's defenseman all alone. And they collapse down. And that's once again is that they feel they have to help out one-on-one, and I think that sends a message to Cranbrook that, you know, hard work is going to get him somewhere, and it also sends a message that you know, obviously the points are wide open.
Jeff's got a slow shot, slid along the ice wide. Babcock headmans a pass to Kowalski, who shoots the puck to the corner. Bolger in against Jeff Scott. Bolger can't come up with the puck. Kowalski is spun around by Lega and then run against the boards. Kowalski swats Lega. That's a waste of time. Ford, I'm off the boards, and Ford skates. A good play to Baldwin. Off Kowalski's skate at the center of game. Ford with the puck off of Fordham's pads. The Colts on the forecheck. Here's Babcock, can't hang on. The puck is a hot potato. Spencer is grabbed by Baldwin and Ford now. Fordham will chase him behind the net. Ghost Riders, three of them. Babcock over the line with Kowalski. And Spencer back checking. Herdman's upended. Fodomnik is on the side. He can't get out. Finally, he gets a puck to center. Now, Ghost Riders haven't taken advantage of too many Colts errors. Here's Bolger. Off the boards. Over the line is Sternberg, and there's a pass right in the stick official. Brandvold off the boards, run by Slodovnik. Babcock, a long pass behind Thornberg offside. Molito with lots of time. Pass intended for Slodovnik, doesn't get there. Redman is back. Gets away from Slodovnik. Fischel will chase him, but Redman gets away easily. A flip pass right in the stick of Thornberg. Here's trouble. Thornberg loses the puck, trying to get around Lega. And Jeff Scott takes a whack at Kennedy. Slodovnik wrists it. Dulowitz leaves the puck for Ford as the Colts on a change. A giveaway. Here's Jeff Scott. His pass is behind Steckman. Redman can't hang on to it. Scott Lega dumps the puck back in and dumps Redman on his way by. Ford off the boards. Jeff Scott has the puck. Almost gave it to Thornberry. Here's Steckman. Drills it off Ford. Fordham with half of Ford's name behind the net. Spencer trying to get loose and does. Here's Jeff Scott. Steckman. Great save by Dimlewicz. Just off the pad. The Ghost Riders totally lost in their own zone. Redman can't get out. Steckman in the corner. Ford takes him out. The puck is kicked right to Fordham, who gives it to Thornberg. 2-on-2. Thornberg to center with Redman. Thornberg over the line. A low shot. Herdman, the save with the pads. Kennedy. Here's Thornberg. Shoots it. Herdman, another save. And Thornberg is upended in the slot. Behind the net, Fordham. And referee Brown blows the whistle. 5 minutes, 29 seconds gone in the third. 3-2 Colts. Let's have a look at that if we can.
I don't know. We'll see it. To me, it looked like it was an inadvertent high stick with, and I think it come off, it was Brad Patterson. But Thornberg just taking a shot. We'll see it right here. Oh no, it was Dave.
Back
Dave
it up Will- again if we can.
Dave Lolito, I think.
Back it up for a minute if we can. Let's have a look at this. Look at the left side of the screen, right as soon as we Mary just tried to get a stick on his stick. And it looks like you got it in the cheek or something. Or the jaw. And they're trying to draw blood. Or they do. Or they don't. He's got a towel there. There's no blood on the ice. It's all in his mustache. Beard. Or whatever that is. Well, he did get whacked.
As I say, I think it was an inadvertent high stick. He'd already had the let the shot go. But he hasn't had any desire to go to the net tonight, and that'll make him even less desirous, I think.
Well, I think he's been one of the bright lights offensively. He and Brad Boulder. Anyway, 3-2 Colts. Game two. The best of seven. Rocky Mountain Junior Hockey League Finals. The Eddie Mountain Subway Cup. Robert Brook throws it off the boards. And the Ghost Riders throw it to center. McLeod dumps it back in, and he's dumped by Travis Corkle. We haven't said this at all this year, but Matt Baldwin has not played a good hockey game tonight for the Colts. He has made a couple of good plays, but he has not been his usual self.
Well, his usual feisty self, he's like a hornet out there that guys are trying to swat away, but he's, he packs a little bit of punch. So, and Malt's usually right in your face, pounding away, and tonight he hasn't been there.
Somebody will get him mad. McGowan flips the puck in, McLeod grabs it. And if you got a left fielder on your ball team who made a catch like that, you'd keep it. So the game is slowed.
Well, it slowed down quite a bit, and you know, I think this is one of the things that Jerry Banks had said, that you know, he felt Fernie had more team speed, so you know, overall through their lineup, and it would be to the Colts' advantage to slow the game down and create as many delays as they could.
Well, they've done that, and the Ghost Riders have given away a ton of scoring chances. Here's Brandvold behind his own net. What was in his mind there?
Well, I think his plan, and it's been Fernie's plan, they have a heck of a time against the Colts' forecheck. So all night long, they've been looking for somebody that's 120 feet away, but they can't seem to get him puck.
Face off in a Ghost Rider zone. Kelly McLeod against Travis Corkle. McLeod always takes his time getting into the faceoff circle to make sure everybody is ready. And we get some pushing and shoving. Bowman, Maltman. Here's Corkle, can't get by Jeff Scott. The puck is dumped to the corner. Corkle, the first man there, away from Scott Lega. Puck goes the other way. Corkle has it in his skates, can't come up with it. McLeod is down. And the Colts doing some pushing and shoving, and the Ghost Riders can't stand up.
Well, Corkle's played a good game, but you know, he's got big Ryan Porter in his wing, and Ryan's gonna start going to the net hard, creating opportunities. And he's been playing on the outside, as far outside as he could get. You know, and until Fernie starts going hard to the net every shift, you know, they're not going to give Cranbrook much trouble. You know, if this is one of those ones where a turnover could cost Cranbrook, but I haven't seen
three blind mice. You just saw John McCauley, Rick Volkestein, and I think.
And who else?
Burnett? No. Anyway.
Al Burnett?
No. Linker. I think it was Linker. Oldenburger. Behind the net to Patterson. Jacob Beck. And down is Kevin Martin as he's stick by Oldenburger. Hostrand! Great save by Herman. Hostrand again. Herman's down. A puck is still loose. and everybody whapping away with sticks and gloves. Well, Herbman, what he's had to, has made some good saves. And there was
two great saves again. And that was, just as we talked about, another giveaway off the stick this time of Brad Patterson coming around behind the net.
Well, look at it here.
You see it right here. Brad Patterson slips. Mike Hofstrand has two opportunities. The puck's still laying loose. Sorry, I said it was Brad Patterson. I think it was Derek Jacobek.
Moon and Hofstrand now in the face-off circle. Colts win the draw. Oldenburger throws it to the other side. Fischel off the glass to the line. Ford keeps a puck in. Hofstrand tries the other side. Oldenburger now against Kevin Martin. And Oldenburger pins him. Fischel in. Gualito in. Three Colts. Huge on the boards. Well, one thing about Bobby Murdoch, if he gives his players one shift, if they don't get the puck out, they're gone. Here is another change.
Now, good job by Cranbrook in their zone that time, though, Terry. Even though they didn't get it out, man on man, they didn't allow Fernie to beat them in little battles along the boards. And that's why, you know, you'll take 100 faceoffs in your zone when there was no opportunity to score, just like that.
Well, they haven't really, except for Hofstrand, but that was Jacobek fell. Here's a shot by McGowan. Babcock spins and turns and wheels, and the shot is stopped. Fordham falls down, and Scott Legg throws a puck in the stands. I was just going to say the Colts didn't get any chances, and then bingo, they get one.
Well, here's the thing, and you know, this is just a little off the subject, but you'll give a goaltender with all the equipment on that he has on and a great big paddle a penalty for shooting a puck out of the zone and never say nothing to a guy that is expected to be able to control the puck. And whether and that time it was Scott Lega, but in the forwards, that's a bad penalty. I know, a little off topic.
Well, we have
bugging me.
We've talked about that before lots too. Here comes Jeff Scott, a long pass to McLeod, and he's tracked down by McGowan. And McGowan's been a real physical force tonight for the Ghost Riders. Off the board is Scott. Scott Lega through Maltman. Here's Branville, right back in again. Neither team playing with a lot of confidence and a lot of authority. Demoskov gets a puck about 4 inches ahead of him. Matt Maltman with one hand, and he'll get a second chance. Now with two hands, and he's a foot from center, and he hits Robert Brook at the source. No ice. Babcock sort of goes after Oldenburger. Stechman has all sorts of time on the boards and flips it to center. Stromquist back in. Wolito is checked. Now gets to center. Wolito again. Stechman on the side. And I know at this time of the year, teams shouldn't be physically tired. It looks like both these teams are mentally tired, Rocky. And here comes Stechman. Gets by Demoskov and gives him a little shot in the neck with his stick. Stromquist up with the puck. Off the glass, it disappears. What a surprise. The bad bounce off the glass.
Well, Stefan Stromquist had the puck 5 times on that shift, and all 5 times he couldn't find anywhere else to shoot it. 3 times to Dave Bolito and 2 times off the boards. And thank goodness for the Cranbrook fans that this gave Mike Vandenkamp a chance to change stuff and maybe give him a little instruction on who he should be passing the puck to.
Black, right? Jeff Scott. And that puck was shot high. In the corners, Latosky, Brad Kennedy. Can't get away from Jacobek. Yep. And Stillwell. Jacobek hog ties him and raffles him to the ice. Kennedy. Now he's going to try to beat everybody. A pass ahead to Thornburg, and he's tripped up by Jeff Scott. Patterson to Jacobek. Jacobek in for Patterson. Patterson still on the puck. Here's Letoski. Lega shot. Lilowitz is down. And he makes a save on the first bounce. 10:18 left in the third. 3-2 Colts.
You know, we sort of, when you're coaching, you sort of have a role. Like in the third period, you don't mind the referee not calling anything as long as it doesn't result. You know, you'll let a hook go or a trip go as long as it doesn't result in a turnover deep in your zone. And that time, Derek Jacobek hot-tied Brad Kennedy, pulled him down, and Colts maintained, you know, had a chance to get control. Now, I don't know if Glenn waited to see that Kennedy got back up and got the puck himself, but it ended up still deep in their zone.
Wade Dublowitz just made a great save off his glove, off his shoulder. In the slot, Kowalski. And Babcock couldn't get to the net against Wolito, who has him totally tied up. Here's Corey Becker. Waits and puts the puck on Fischel's stick. Fischel didn't want it. Wolito, this time to Slodovnik. He'll get the center and dump it in. Dublowitz in front, and he takes his time. On the side. Ghost Rider's a long pass. Babcock didn't want to touch it with his stick. No icing. Scott Lega to Fischel. McLeod. Fischel dumps the puck to Brooks' corner. Brook is in. Dublowitz, an easy save. McLeod goes to the net. Dublowitz hangs on. 9:24 left. 3-2 Colts.
Well, here's a game again where the lack of desire by the other team in one to drive hard into the other zone plays right in the Colts' hands now. It's a 3-2 hockey game, you know, and as a visiting team, that's, you know, you'd like to be ahead 3-2, but you don't mind being down by a goal. Cranbrook's playing with a ton of confidence, and Fernie's running around.
Well, I don't think the Colts are playing with that much confidence that we've usually seen. They're a little bit hesitant themselves. Here's McLeod. Baldwin's loose. The puck hits behind the net. Brook! And that's knocked down by Brandvold. Brook at an open corner. Maltman out of the corner. Going to the net is Scott. So is Maltman, and he shoots the puck back to McLeod. On the side, Zimmerman, who's done zip tonight. To Brandvold, who can't get out. Maltman's run from behind. Here's McLeod. Dublowitz, a great save by McLeod. On McLeod. And Chad Zimmerman, you mentioned it before. There was a gain. The captain coughs the puck up in his own zone.
And then doesn't go get it and doesn't go back in the zone and help out. And that's what I think what's killing Fernie tonight, Terry, is not Chad Zimmerman. It's the amount of dozens they've got on that team right now. They got a whole bunch of guys or don'ts. They got a whole bunch of guys that don't want to get involved. They got a whole bunch of guys that don't want to drive to the net. They got a whole bunch of guys that don't want to back check. They got a whole bunch of guys that don't want to give themselves up. And they don't have enough guys that want to do something.
Well, we've got more action in the dog pound on the tsunami. And there they go again. The Moskov gets away from Steckman and reverses back the other way and away from Spencer as well. Unexpected the pass was Thornburg. He ripped one! He had Herdman beat it, just missed. Redman is in against Fordham. Redman still on the puck. And boy, Domoskov backs up against Steckman. Baldwin high off the glass. You gotta watch the goofy bounces. Here's Redman. Wolito tracks him down and hangs on. Spencer away. Cross-ice pass to Fordham. He's against Baldwin. Fordham over the line. A wrister. Dublowitz saves it and then bats it to the corner. Redman in his corner. Trying to get out. Can't against Patterson. Patterson to Fordham. Fordham still has the puck. Back to Patterson. Patterson behind the net. Trying to center it. Domoskov stops that play. On the other side, Baldwin against Spencer. Kennedy now against Fordham. Fordham wins that battle. Here's the point. Oldenburger wrists it. Dublowitz, a glove save. And Kennedy hits for the bench where he should go.
once again, that whole play starts. Travers Redman won't take the puck deep. He stops along the boards because he saw Dave Bolito coming. Can't keep a stick on the ice because he's bracing himself to get hit. Can't keep the puck in his zone. Doesn't want to back check. And then when he gets back there, doesn't want to get the take a check to make a play. Coughs the puck up deep. Doesn't get back into play. Not only does his man come out of the corner untouched, another man comes out of the corner, and it comes out to the point where he's standing, and they get a shot off that. That's what's killing Fernie tonight. Too many don'ts and won'ts.
Well, Mike Vandekamp started the game with blonde hair, the coach, and he's got some gray ones after watching this performance from some of his better players. Icing is waved off. Ryan Porter, the first man by 15 feet, becomes the second man by 6 feet. Here's the puck at the point. Ford wrists it to the corner. Ghost Riders in deep. Scott plugging away against Bohm, who hasn't played much. Mike Fischel all by himself for the Colts. Overskates the puck and just shoots it to the corner. The Colts on a change. Porter. His pass hits Brooke. Oldenburger gets a puck to McLeod, who's at the line and falls. Boom. To Porter, who gets a stick on it, and that's all. Oldenburger to Maltman. Maltman bodied by Hofstrand, and Oldenburger shoots a puck to Demoskov, who rips it into the crowd. Get a new puck. 6:38 left, 3-2 Colts.
Well, the Colts have done a great job carrying the neutral zone. Everything that when Fernie tries to bring the puck out, they can't make that easy 8 or 10 foot pass to spring somebody loose. They've got to have somebody, and it invariably ends up with their back to the play, trying to pick up a 35-foot or 40-foot pass. You know, and you're not going to do that very often in any league, let alone this league. And when you have a lack of desire to get involved with Oldenburger, Lega, and Walido, it's a waste of a pass.
Here's Baldwin. Going to the net is Hofstrand, and Herdman makes a good play to get the puck out of trouble. Brooke gives it away in his own zone. Hofstrand behind his own net, centers it. Martin has his shot deflected. Demoskov has to back up. Rocky, the Colts get the puck. Here's Maltman, right in, and he shot it to the crease. Great move, he had Dumlewitz down and just shot it to the crease. McLeod shot, a loose puck. And the whistle goes. We got a pile up. And Maltman, a great move around Dublowitz, and then split the puck to the crease.
Well,
Colts did both ends.
A couple things, Terry. The Colts defensemen hold the blue line so well, and that's one of the reasons they're able to keep pressure on. Right there, Fernie was afraid because they know that their forwards get caught so deep so often to stand up, and if they had stood up, they could have thrown it in. As it was, they got to back up and give a 3-on-2, which turns into a 4-on-2 because Fernie's forwards aren't working hard to get back. Now Maltman, with a great move, slides it right through the crease here.
Off the boards, Martin. Off the boards to Lega, who's on the wrong team. Spencer, Fordham's loose. Randvold is there to cut off the pass. Spencer on the other side. Can't get it to Steckman this time. Ghost Riders, Martin and Steckman, two 12s, end up with a puck. Zimmerman, his pass behind Hofstrand. Lega wraps it to center. Here they go, three of them. Three Colts, Fordham, Spencer, and Steckman. Fordham tries to beat Branville. Spencer can't get a good shot away against Kevin Martin, who was back checking. Here's Branville, who's been a force tonight on the rush, and then gives it to Oldenburger. A long shot in deep. Walido for the Colts. Here's Jacobek loose. Demoskov will catch him. Patterson in to stop the breakout. Babcock throws a puck to an open corner in his own zone, and Demoskov shoots the puck off Brown's head. Patterson at center ice gets a puck in deep. Aaron Kowalski for the Ghost Riders. 4:52 left. Ghost Riders over the line. Kowalski against Oldenburger. Behind the net is Babcock. Jeff Scott will chase him. Jacobek, a two-hander on Brad Bolger. Scott can't get the puck out. Neither can Patterson, and Jacobek's turn. He flips it to center, right back in. Strongquist can't get off the ice fast enough. Oldenburger off the boards to center. Baldwin right back in. No icing. 4:13 left. Jeff Scott off the boards. Out over the line. Maltman gives Bolger an elbow and ends up with a puck. Maltman to the line. Offside by 5 feet is McLeod.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is tonight's 50-50 number.
4 minutes left. 3-2 Colts.
Well, once again,
3-7-2-5-0.
No, I don't have that one this time.
You don't but share anyway. I'm not hoping for you anymore.
Bolger and Babcock with good work along the boards down low, and Anthony Baldwin won't step up to keep that puck in and gets caught in no man's land, standing still. He's got to back up. And there goes another chance, you know, and you got to start taking chances with 4 minutes left.
Well, I agree with you, though, that the Ghost Riders forwards are just brutal coming back out of the cold zone. And the defensemen, they start to go, and they see no help, and they've got to back up. And then they are in no man's land. Thornburg just thrown to the ice by Lega. At the point, Baldwin shot. Kennedy can't get a stick on it. Maltman to center to Brooke. And you know Brooke will just throw it in deep. Colts on a change. Thornburg. Oh, look at this. Oh.
Well, Ben doesn't want to get hit.
Oldenburger back. Kennedy will chase him. The eight payout. Wolito. Ahead is Spencer. Steckman's loose. Can't get the puck. Brooke on the boards. Taken out by Demoskov. Ghost Riders out. And Thornburg couldn't hang on to it. Puck, they were gone with a 2-on-1. Demoskov. Colts. Wolito. And it was neutral zone. Gets it into the Ghost Rider zone. Demoskov will try again. There's a long pass off of Kennedy's glove. Jeff Scott will just turn and wrap it off the boards. There's Thornburg. In deep to Kennedy. Scott. Thornburg watches him. Spencer on the side. Can't get it out against Demoskov. And we get a whistle, 2:37 left. And you can say for this game that really no player has really stepped forward for the whole game and tried to take the bull by the horns.
From either team.
Either team, right.
But then, you know, at the end of this, Cranbrook is going to say, listen, we didn't play very well in game one and we won, and we didn't play very well in game two and we won. You know, what's going to happen when we get in a roll? And I think Fernie's going to ask themselves the same question. What happens if Cranbrook gets in a roll? Now, I get the same feeling, Terry. Fernie hasn't given me the feeling that they can beat Cranbrook.
Well, it looks like either they don't want to or they don't have the confidence. Because, boy, they certainly had a lot of chances in throwing them away. Lega is hacked by Hofstrand. McLeod. Here's Brandvold on the side. Kevin Martin gets away from a check, and he'll come to center. He'll go 1-on-2. There's Demoskov. Slow to join the rush, but hits a puck behind the net. Pinned by Scott. Martin looks at Hofstrand at the point, doesn't give him the puck. Hofstrand. Jeff Scott makes a good play with his skate to take the puck away. Here's Demoskov, though. He'll get a shot. High, Herdman down. Martin's in. A loose puck behind the net. McLeod, Hofstrand, Kevin Martin, Jeff Scott, Scott Lega, and Matt Maltman. They all get a whistle. 1:51 left.
We'll see it here.
It could save by Herdman.
It's saved by Sean Herdman, and that's what, you know, you're asking Herdy to pull this one out of the fire for you right now. You know, you haven't played very well. You're up 3-2, and you got to hold on for another 1:51. Fernie has really got to pick up their work ethic, and they got some guys. They got to have guys that want to go pay the price in front of the net, and right now they got three on there that don't want to do it.
And you're going to have to pick some stars, too. Ryan Lazon was having a cup of tea at the Ghost Riders bench. And we paused 1 second.
Well, there's that 1 second off the clock that might kill you.
Ghost Rider, Stromquist. Herdman, a great save. Out! And Babcock over top of him. But Herdman, a great save and a good shot by Stefan Stromquist. Well,
what I had mentioned before, Terry, was you got to have guys out there that want to go to the net at this time. All you have to do is have one guy going to the net with that rebound that was out 15 feet. And do you see anybody? The closest guy is Brandon Babcock, who rotated out to the blue line, I guess in case the rebound come out that far. Now they got Ben Thornburg, who hasn't gone to the net all night.
And we won't from this spot. Look at this lineup. Kennedy against McLeod. The puck goes behind the net. Oldenburger for the Colts. Pass the center to McLeod. Over the line, he'll get the puck in deep. Anthony Baldwin rings the boards. Thornburg lets it go. Baldwin, chance number two. Right on the stick of Fordham. This time it's Stromquist, but Spencer will block him off. And Kennedy just shoots the puck down the ice. Right on Herdman. Ghost Riders get a break. Herdman around behind the net, and there's two Ghost Riders going the wrong way. Polito, his pass is in Steckman skates. Steckman to Fordham, to Spencer in deep. 1 minute and 3 seconds left. Baldwin is a Ghost Riders. Need something here, obviously. Stromquist, as Thornburg tries to stick handle out of his own zone. Babcock gives it to Brooke. Brooke in deep. In the crowd. 44 seconds left.
That puck that went all the way down the ice on Sean Herdman, he set it up. Dave Alito took it, and he was only going one way. He set himself up to go one way. He came around the net, turned to his right. Ben Thornburg went by the pizza sign, by the Dairy World sign, and tried to stay that 80 feet away from Dave Alito that he's managed to do all night and look like he's working hard. Colts are going to kill you if you don't put pressure on their defenseman turning the puck up ice.
Waltman, McLeod, and Brooke, Alito, and Lega for the Colts. Hofstrand, Martin, Baldwin, Granvold. And on the other side is Thornburg. Dumped in. Lega's back. He'll get it off the boards to the line. Granvold kicks it. Brooke stops it. Lega off the boards to the line again. Granvold, it's high in the air. As the Ghost Riders have pulled their goalie. A face-off at center ice. 22 seconds left.
Well, 1,010? Good guess. Here's something, Terry. And this is, I've noticed this all night long, but that puck's back at the blue line. One Ferdy guy, two Cranbrook guys. Cranbrook wins every time. And in this situation, when they've got one, you got to have two. You've got one extra man. So when they got three, you have four.
Spencer against Hofstrand. Hofstrand wins the draw. Granvold, Thornburg. Baldwin gets the puck in deep. Kennedy goes against Polito. Polito wins. Granvold shoots it. Herdman with the glove. 9 seconds. Well, Thornburg wanted to go through eight guys at the blue line.
Well, he tried to go through eight guys, except he stopped and threw 8 pounds of snow and then left the puck there. You thought that he played a good game tonight. I haven't seen anything that he's done that would make me want to stick him out there in this type of situation. But maybe Mike's hamstrung because he doesn't have many more guys out there that want to do anything. A quick note, Morgan Bailey pulled his groin and has been out since the second period.
And he had lots of chances. 4 or 5 good scoring chances for the Colts, and he did get a breakaway goal to get them going. Hofstrand against McLeod, the two best on the faceoffs. And the linesman tries his best, and he is trying his best to not throw either one of them out. McLeod wins. Walido doesn't need the puck. Kennedy behind the net, centers it. Brook is there. That's it. Colts lead 2-0. And the best of seven.
Now that, you know, you got 30 guys banging their sticks on the ice. That's like roughing after the whistle. Now, where was that intensity? Where was that desire? Where was that drive? They had a bunch of guys that went to the finals last year using that drive, using that desire. I never saw one guy want to pay any kind of a price, you know, and that's the difference, I think, tonight. Now, Cranbrook wasn't all that much better than them, but Fernie just didn't want to pay the price. Now they're down 2-0. Cranbrook's got, you know, and Cranbrook is. You see, have a look at those guys. They know they didn't play very well at all, and they still won this game. They're waiting to get on a roll. I don't know what Fernie can do.
Well, we've already mentioned it a few times that we both think a lackluster affair, and both coaches, I think, would agree with that. The first game out of the same mold, this one out of the same mold. It looks like both teams are playing like they don't have a lot of playoff experience, but they do. And I mentioned earlier, I think both teams look mentally tired. Well, pick three stars.
They're picking Wade Dubowitz, and I think Wade was the reason they stayed in the game. Matt Maltman, who we didn't think played a very good game, gets second star.
Now you pick yours. They pick Dubowitz, Maltman, and McLeod. 3-2-1.
Now I thought tonight that again, you know, Dave Wellito did a lot of things. He got the second goal, and but he's just. He creates so much doubt in the minds of the forwards going to the net, whether he's going to put that big body or that big stick or one of those big elbows in their way. You know, just his presence out there makes a huge difference. It's a huge difference to the Colts. But I think tonight he did what he had to do. Kept the puck out of harm's way in his own end. Got a goal. He'd be my third star. Wade Dubowitz.
I agree.
My second star. And
I'm
Sean,
in all 3 years.
Sean Herdman was my first star. You know, Sean had 26 saves tonight. But I'll tell you, he had 10 saves, I thought, four in the first, two in the second, and then there was four there pretty much in a row in the third that kept Cranbrook in the game. And once again, I don't think they played that well tonight. But,
no.
You know, Herdy's, you know, you got to depend on your goaltender. And you ask him during the season, win us one or two or three games, you know, we'll leave you alone and we're not going to help you out. Well, 26 shots, you know, that's a testament to Fernie not going to the net. But they did have some good scoring opportunities, but from out, you know, high out. They didn't create any traffic around the net, but Herdy, you know, he made some great saves from out far, I think four right in a row, and with his left foot in the first period alone. That you know, but those are long shots, and Herdy should handle those, but he still played well, and he did what he had to. He stopped the difficult shot.
Right.
That's
when he had to.
When he had to, and you know, not that Wade Dubowitz
didn't.
He made some
difficult shots look easy by challenging, and as you mentioned, nobody going to the net, but Herdman read the play, and that was it.
Well, I just think that you know, and it was a toss-up, really. Like Wade Dubowitz, you know, 44 shots, definitely are the busy, far busier, obviously. You know, that goes unsaid, but also far busier with the amount of traffic the Colts throw his way in front of his net. You know.
Although I think both goaltenders had an equal number of hard chances.
Yeah, and no doubt about that. But I think that it's not only the hard chances, it's the nervousness that the goaltenders get when there's one or two or three guys in their crease banging away, hacking away. And the Colts did that tonight, and Fernie didn't do that tonight. Your three stars.
Well, I picked them.
No, I picked them, and you agreed.
I'd agree. I agree wholeheartedly. Wellito, Dubowitz, and Herdman. Like,
well,
100%. I mentioned in the third period that I didn't think Matt Maltman had played that well for him, and maybe my expectations of him are getting too high, and he got the second star. And Kelly McLeod, who's played well in the whole playoffs, he and Maltman, I think, have been the two best forwards for the Colts. They were 1-2 stars tonight. I didn't think they deserved it tonight. But that's, I don't know who picked them. It doesn't matter, does it?
No. I think I liked, I liked the way Derek Jacobek came back and how hard he works and what a thorn he is in the side.
Yep.
And I think those three guys, you know, are definitely three of the hardest workers on the team. You know, there was guys that came tonight and just floated. You know, Robbie Brook, four goals, one assist. I didn't really notice him out there tonight. And that's,
you know, Bobby and Nels had, talked about that, is getting that consistent effort, game in, game out, and now it's shift in, shift out in the playoffs. So both teams still looking for that. I think Terry is a consistent effort and, you know, and playing the game with some desire and drive. Not enough of it in concerted effort from either team.
Nope.
So, but result 2-0, Cranbrook lead in the finals, back in Fernie tomorrow night, and now it's a must game. You know, Fernie's hung themselves out
game
on the
three.
Wire. Game three. Usually, obviously we talked about this before, the game four syndrome, but game three is probably more important than, you know, it is the most important game. They can't afford to go down 3-0 coming back here on Tuesday night. So a must game, and to get themselves back in the series. They've got to win tomorrow night, and nobody but themselves to blame for, you know, certainly a lackluster effort here tonight, and by all accounts a lackluster effort on Thursday in Fernie.
Well, I don't think either coach is going to be happy with the way their teams have been playing. The only difference is Murdoch has got two wins, and Mike Van de Kamp has zero, so he's a lot unhappier.
Yep. But, you know, once again, I think, you know, a saving grace Sunday, tomorrow, you know, Fernie can go back and say, listen, we didn't play very well at all and only lost by one goal in Cranbrook's rink. But on the same hand, you know, Cranbrook says we didn't, you know, good teams win when they play poorly.
Yep.
You know, and that's an old adage, and it's true every year. It doesn't matter what sport, what team. You know, when you can win when you don't play well, that puts, you know, that thought, you know, Fernie's got to say, well, you know, we've got to suck it up and come back and be a different team in our own building tomorrow night, or it's over. And, you know, you'll see what kind of heart those kids have and what kind of desire tomorrow. Because if they're, you know, if they put themselves up against it, you know, with this type of effort, they're in tough coming in here Tuesday trying to win game four.
And I think the whole thing with Fernie, the way I see it, is that Fernie has got to be disappointed in their offense that was horrible. They caused more problems than anything else in the game tonight for both teams.
Well, just, you know, that lack of, you know, I felt sorry for Fernie's defense tonight. They can't afford to stand up. They don't have, there's never a high guy. Now, that sometimes is not the, you know, that's the coaching staff that has got to drill it into those guys that, you know, we've got to give these guys an opportunity. And Cranbrook's so good on the turnover, you know. When they turn that puck over, Cranbrook invariably has two, you know, and it's usually an odd man rush. You know, it's, whether it's a defenseman jumping up into the rush or those forwards. So Cranbrook, a lot more disciplined in the playoffs than they were during the regular season, looking after their own end and also on the attack.
Okay, end of game two. Colts beat the Ghost Riders 3-2. They go back to Fernie, as you mentioned, tomorrow night. They're back here Tuesday night for game four. Right?
Game four.
Which is, or could be, the end. But Colts lead the series 2-0. 30 minutes for Rick Allen from the Cranbrook Silverdome, and that's it tonight for Rocky Hockey.
This production is brought to you in part by C's TV Repair. They're located at 307 King Street Northwest in Cranbrook, right across from Beaver Lumber. C's TV repairs everything from TVs, VCRs, car stereos, amplifiers, microwaves, electronic organs, and hi-fis. C's also has a home pickup and delivery service on console models. All work is performed and guaranteed by a qualified electronic technician. C's TV Repair is a proud production sponsor on Shaw Cable 11. Production is brought to you by Presto Car Wash and Mr. Petrogas, which is located at 1733 Cranbrook Street North, right on the strip. Presto Car Wash offers a full service car wash, and they specialize in laser washing and hand bay washing of any size vehicle. Mr. Petro is a full service station and offers super savings on gas, plus friendly prompt service. Shaw Cable 11 would like to thank Presto Car Wash and Mr. Petrogas for being proud sponsors of community television programming on Shaw Cable 11.
This production is brought to you in part by Binky's Auto Clean. Owner Paul Hobart employs 3 people and specializes in complete interior and exterior cleaning and polishing of your vehicle. Binky's Auto Clean is located at number 3, 403 Industrial Road A in Cranbrook, and their motto is, how your car looks is a reflection on us. Binky's Auto Clean, a proud sponsor of community programming on Shaw Cable 11.